kitchen, yes.
Could be easier to say. Kitchen apron. I might not say that very, very quickly. But this is it. This is it in different colours. This is how it was in the magazine.
Yes, yeah.
We've got a different take on it for you today in a beautiful marina style.
It's more
which
sort
I
love of it. Seaside.
Yeah, I'm enjoying
seaside
it.
Seaside beach hut.
So for summer. The full kit, it's $18.95. But as part of the kit, you get all of the fabric, full instructions, and even the thread. I love that.
Yeah.
Even the thread is included.
Everything so there you need.
Everything that you need is good to go. Just basically add time and pins.
Indeed, yes.
Perfect. And the instructions. Well, you've got the instructions. Yeah. So what I love about the instructions is that they are so clear, easy to follow. Of course, we've got this show to show you how to do them. But look, they're just great quality as well. Once you've made it once, you can make it again in other materials. Yeah. But once you've got it there, you are good to go. Step-by-step instructions. You see, this is what you do, isn't it? This is all these step-by-step instructions and the photos. Nice.
And you get half a metre of each of the fabrics, so you can make it in anything after you've made it with the ones in your kit.
I love the kit. I have to say. what we like to do here.
Morning.
Good morning.
How are you, my lovely?
I'm very well, thank you.
Good.
How are
you're looking fabulous, loving your top.
Thank you.
Now, I see you've come prepared then
I'm
this morning.
I'm all kitted out, yes, ready to go.
So, tell me what. Should we just go through what we've got on the table? Because I'm presuming these are all essentials that you would think of in your quilting workshop, really.
Absolutely. This is. The long ruler, really versatile, great for cutting binding, squaring up quilts, cutting across the full width of fabric.
Yeah.
This one, great for smaller, cutting half square triangles. I'm going to be cutting some diamonds using this later.
Fantastic. And then this, we've not seen this one before.
This is great. I've used this to do the isosceles triangle.
Yes, yes, yes. I said this morning, or somebody will say isosceles today.
And I got it right first time.
Yes.
Yes, this is great. A 45 degree... triangular ruler, brilliant for triangles. I use it for diamonds as well.
That's brand new. We've not had that before. It's £12.95, that one there. I'll just lift it up for you, because it really is, can you see it there, really cute little ruler. And now, the first two are ones that all of our experts have all said, oh, we'll start with those, have to have them. This is a new one to us, so we'll get new tips about that today. So, let's just start off. Now, what we've done is you used the fat quarters that we sent you
to
create this lovely little, I mean, it's a very short table runner, but it's just a kind of example of what you can do, really,
yes.
Isn't it?
I love this design with the triangles. I didn't go for isosceles again then.
Yes. Chicken. No, we've done that. Now.
It's lovely for quilts on a larger scale as well. For a cot quilt with more softer baby colours.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's a really versatile shape. I really like the triangles.
Okay, right. So I don't know where to start. I wouldn't know where to start. So you've got to get the fat quarters. Where'd you go from there?
The first step is cutting out. Press all your fabric first to make sure you've worked with nice flat fabric. There's no wrinkles that will just cause the measurements to be out slightly.
So I notice you've gone for the kind of the blues. Is this the berry? This is the berry one, the winter berry one, I think you've gone for, haven't you? The lovely colours in there.
Yes.
Really, really gorgeous colours in there.
They work really nicely together.
Yes.
Quite striking ones.
Well, that's the good thing about buying a fat quarter, isn't it? Someone else has done all of the work for you, haven't they? By choosing all the colours and everything like that.
Yes, that's the area I lack confidence, really, is putting colours together. So I love a bundle where it's done for me. I know it when I see it in other people's. I love the colours they put together, but I don't quite feel confident myself.
It's not an issue, but it's something that a lot of people, if you haven't worked in colour, think would go into a shop and be a bit kind of bemused by all the colours and think, oh, I couldn't put that and that together. Whereas a lot of the time, if the colours are together in nature, I think that they look fabulous together. Okay, these are the fat quarters we're doing. This is the iris one. Eight-piece fat quarter, £9.95. I'll take you through it in a second. Don't worry, we'll take you through it all in a second. I just want to get started.
Well, first off, I would use the long ruler. If you're working with a larger piece of fabric, a full piece of fabric, you'd fold it over, make sure the sides, the threads are running parallel.
Yeah.
And then you can use this side of the ruler against the fold, so you know it's straight, and just straighten off the edge of your fabric.
Right.
Because working from a straight edge just makes everything so much easier.
Yes, of course. And you can't guarantee when a piece of fabric arrives that it's actually the top cutting is actually on the grain, can you?
No, I mean almost never.
Yes.
So.
So now for quilting, it's very important. Precision is one of the main key factors, isn't it?
It just makes everything easier, matching your points up. If everything's the same shape and size, it does. It makes lining everything up.
Yeah. Okay, so what are you doing, there then?
Well, I would straighten the edge, the top edge first, but that's already done. Now for this, I wanted triangles that were 4.5 inches tall. So I cut a strip that was 5 inches wide. So I added 1/4 inch at the bottom and the top to make, so I need, for a 4.5 inch triangle, I need a 5 inch strip.
Okay, because when you're quilting, you leave a 1/4 inch seam allowance, don't you?
Yes. Okay. And often you can get 1/4 inch foot for a machine, which just makes keeping your seams nice and even, 1/4 inch.
Of course. That
we're looking for rotary cutters and then rice cutters.
The rotary cutters are all there. You have a choice of three today. I'll go through that in a second for you.
Okay.
Right.
So I'll cut a 5 inch.
So you're using the 45 millimetre blade, which is the one that all of our experts seem to prefer. That's the one they use the most of.
Yes, I always have this to hand. It's the one I use most regularly.
I'll go through all of these. Oh, there's that one. It's the 1495 45 millimetre clover rotary cutter with soft touch fasten. I'll go through them obviously later. And then if you're looking for the long ruler, that's just across the bottom there. So what have you done then? You've just made a cut A piece. How wide?
5 inches.
5 inches wide.
I'll cut another one, just so I've got two to go at. This one might need straightening up first.
Using the ruler and the rotary cutter, it looks so easy to get a completely straight edge.
It is. And also, it's really quick. So much quicker than... More precise and quicker than
you have to move the fabric, do you? Because I've always straightened the scissors and everything, but... To cut that with scissors, you'd really have to lift the fabric, cut along. I'm not saying you can't do it with scissors, but it's a very, very efficient way, isn't it, of using it.
There we go.
Okay,
a nice straight edge, and I'll do a 5-inch.
So you're using the long ruler, the 60 by 16 centimetre ruler, to measure out a 5-inch column or strip of fabric.
Yes, and if you're doing binding, this ruler's perfect. You can do big, long lengths of binding in one go. Okay. And when using a rotary cutter, cut away from it. I try not to swing it around too much. That's lethal as well. But cut away from you.
Okay. Yeah, of course, always cut away. But that's like with any kind of crafting, isn't it? When you're whittling or anything, it's kind of...
Yes,
you're
always
taught to do it away from you, aren't you?
Yes. Okay.
And Hannah says she always... Hannah's our producer today, by the way. She peels her potatoes away from her.
Oh, I don't actually. No,
I'm not actually thinking about it. I don't.
Yeah.
Yes. Anyway, we weren't going to Hannah's cookery skills this morning.
I've not had any potato peeling related incidents, so.
We can buy potatoes already peeled now, can't you? Or leave the skin on. I leave the skin on when I use them. But there you go. Right. It's not a cookery show. It's a sewing show. It's sewing quarter. So hang on. Do you put the two fabrics together now?
Because you can cut several layers at a time. With this, I cut through 3 or 4. Strips at a time. I did cut it into the triangles really, really quickly that way. Now, I'd start by squaring up and use a small square.
Using the square ruler.
A straight edge, because I'm going to cut the half triangles with this ruler.
Oh, okay. I know you're using the small cutting mat. Is that because if you don't need, or first of all, you haven't got a big area, but if you're just cutting smaller pieces, you don't need the big cutting mat. You can just use the smaller cutting mat there.
Plus, also, you can spin the mat when it's smaller.
Yes.
Makes it a little easier. That there.
Okay. So now we haven't used this triangular one before. We're intrigued by this.
Spin the mat. I'll practice off the fruit.
So what's the advantage of using the triangular one to the square one or the long one?
For triangles, it's just perfect. It's precise. You'd be trying to work out the angles from the lines. I mean, it could be done, but it's more confusing. It'd take a bit longer.
Okay.
I'm going to use mine, which I have added my handy bit of tape.
Oh, okay. Now, I saw that. It's lucky you said that, because when we came onto the set, I was about to pull that off, thinking, oh, somebody's left a bit of sellotape on that one. Can you explain it?
This is my handy marker, because when I'm cutting out a few shapes, my mind, well, when I'm doing anything, my mind often wanders.
Oh, hang on, they did. Sorry, I'm just clicking off again. Some people didn't see the manky bit of tape on there. That's nice, isn't it? So just this is a little tip, but I don't know what it's signifying at the moment. That's all.
Well, these triangles I'm going to cut without the point on.
Right.
So get rid of the excess tail. And a quarter of an inch above is that dotted line there.
Right.
So if you can see, these lines here are the seam allowance. So this will be the actual area of your triangle marked by these lines.
Yeah.
So if I that to the top edge, so this a quarter of an inch above the point of the seam allowance. Mm-hmm. I've just added this tape because it shows me where the bottom of the fabric. So that's what I'm cutting to.
You've put a piece of tape on to mark up where the bottom of the fabric is.
Yes. Yeah. So I know I'm cutting that size of triangle.
Okay, brilliant.
And this is the centre line of the triangle, but you want to add the quarter of an inch seam allowance,
of course,
which they've handily got there, so you can line up that in the corner. So I've got the top up there, and that matches on with my handy tape line.
We are creating this lovely, well, cutting triangles for a lovely quilt that Jo's made for us.
And so these will be our two end points. And triangles.
Oh, okay, so you're saving those, you're not throwing those away. Jo's known as the queen of using every little bit that's chopped off. The other day we were making this little doorstop cat, and it was like, oh, we'll save that for the eye, we'll save that. And I said, well, using these two bits for? She said, I don't know, but I'm saving them.
I keep everything. Well, it can all be used for something. If you're right-handed, you want your fabric that you're cutting to the right.
Oh, no, Hannah, that's a good tip there. Yeah.
There we go.
Left-handed, you see. So you just do it the other way round if you were left-handed, Jo?
Yes, I think so.
OK. We'll get Hannah down in a minute. She can show us.
My son's left-handed as well. So.
OK, so now that's the actual triangles cut there.
Carry on along like that.
So the ruler is making it a lot quicker, isn't it? Without using, because obviously you've got the angles on the square and the long one, but actually just having the triangular one is just making it so much more simple, isn't it?
It is. It makes it adorable. And you don't have to think, especially if you've got your tape. You don't have to think too hard. And if you find as you progress along that this angle here isn't quite right, maybe it's not lining up, the bottom line isn't quite straight, you could just recut that to fit and then carry on.
But in theory, it should be, shouldn't it?
It should be using
the ruler and... I suppose, like I say, most people buy the long one and the square one to start with, and then you kind of, because there are so many different rulers that you can get, you'd kind of move on to this one. But I just love them all. It's like stationery and notepads, isn't it? You never have enough of them, really.
And you can hang them up on the wall, keep them safe when you're not using them. They've all got holes in, and a nice ruler display on your sewing room wall.
Okay, brilliant.
So I cut three or four. Depending on the thickness of the fabric.
Of course.
So I had quite a stack quite quickly. I'm going quite slowly now.
No. It's good to we just see you doing it because you get used to the flow of doing it, don't you? Now, I've got a couple of books to show you as well during this hour as well. I'll just get Amy to pass me one of them and I'll just go through it because I've got two really, really lovely books to show you. Now, remember, that's the triangular ruler that is up on the screen at the moment and the rotary cutters across the bottom there. Okay, I've started off with All Things Quilting here. So really, it's available to buy. Because it's quilting day today, as you can see behind me. All Things Quilting by Alex Anderson. Now, do you know what? This is fabulous because you think that, oh, the first page is just going to be a quilt for you to make, whatever. It's not. There's really lovely illustrations. But look, the anatomy of the quilt basically shapes. So if you've not made a quilt before, what you need in your sewing room to do the quilt, then is all the your physical setup of the space that you're going to need when you went. So tools and notions. Oh, now look, it looks a bit like our table. Look, there's the rotary cutters in the different sizes. You've got the scissors and everything. Really, really lovely, isn't it? But it's so it breaks everything down so clearly, doesn't it? But then look, we move on to fabric ideas. We move on to all different basics there. How to cut the different shapes. Even isosceles triangle. isosceles triangle. What are we doing there? You see, Jack, showing you on. That, now they're using a square ruler to us. There's obviously we've got the isosceles triangle ruler and everything. Just really lovely. And then you move on to the actual quilting techniques. And I did. Oh.
That's nice.
Beautiful, isn't it? Absolutely gorgeous. Hannah's obviously read this book. She knows every page. She knows every page. She's saying, oh, next John, you'll see this. Oh, look. There's so many ideas, aren't there? And you know what? You can't go wrong. £19.95 for all things quilting. It's lovely. I'll just spin it around so you can see the back as well there. From the first step to the last stitch, learn to quilt the Alex Anderson way. And there she is. There she is, look. I love that picture of her. She looks so happy there, doesn't she? I'll show you the other book in a second, because we're ready to move on to the next stage, I believe.
Piecing triangles can take a bit of getting used to.
Why?
Because they don't quite line up as you would expect them to.
Right.
So if you're joining them like that, you would...
Oh, yes.
It's the seam allowance that has to line up. So from there, should I mark it with a pen? That'd be a bit easier. This is your seam allowance. So that's the bit that has to line up with the other one so that they fit flush together.
Now, don't worry if you're sitting at home thinking, she's drawn on that fabric with a biro. It's the most fantastic. Everybody uses this. Oh, there it is, £3.45. It's a vanishing. It vanishes. You can draw a line, and within 48 hours, sometimes much quicker, sometimes it just disappears. You can wipe it off with a cloth as well, but you don't need to, because within 48 hours, that will have disappeared. Do you know what? Add that to your basket, £3.45. It's stunning.
Right. Sew that together?
Oh, yes, please,
if you want to. Hit the machine.
So do you have to take care, because obviously you're now sewing on the bias, aren't you? Because it's a triangle.
Yes.
Seams are, the edges are on the bias, aren't they? Which means it's like slightly more stretchy, isn't it?
Yes, it is. And some people don't like... I quite enjoy it because that flexibility, if it's not quite lining up or fitting, just give it a little pull.
Okay, and so what were we saying about precision there, Jo?
Well, no, so it lines up, yes. Precision so, with cheating, I think, is...
So now I notice you didn't line the top, well, we'll see when you've stitched it. You didn't line the top edge with the top edge up on that one.
I didn't.
You're right there.
There we go. Just rearrange that. I mean, you can pin, if you want to pin beforehand. I'm not much of a pinner.
Right. Which we've learnt already.
Yes.
Oh.
I horrified my mum.
Yes. Now, what I meant by you don't line the tops up, just button that down on the when you've trimmed it.
Just snip away the threads. So there is...
So there's the little, what do you call, dog...
The dog ears, tails?
Tails, or? Dog ears, dog tails at the top there. But when you then press them out, obviously it's not going to be in a square because you've started, you know what I mean? It's kind of an, I don't know what that, trapezium shape almost, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, yes. It is a trapezium.
It is
a trapezium. Where did that come from on
We're
a Saturday
ourselves.
Morning at 8:20? Okay, so then, now, I suppose what you have to do is, when you're, I don't know where the quilt's gone, but when you have to, the corners are very important. I mean, doing squares is difficult enough, but finding points I'll just show you on the actual quilt. Here, I'll just get Amy to pass it in to me. Thank you, Amy. Where the points are, it's really, I mean, because you don't want them to miss, do you? The points are very important, hitting the points,
yes.
Isn't it?
When you're sewing this way, this time you're not sewing along the bias, it's cut.
On the straight,
so that makes it a little bit easier. I do pin those, just to make sure.
I mean, we'll get to that, obviously we'll get to that in a minute, but it's quite important that you get all your points matching at the same point, isn't it, on a triangular one. It's very, very, it's harlequin, isn't it, that pattern. So then the next one, is there a trick of matching up the seam allowance on the next one? Is it literally...
You just want your little triangle overlapping... And
the dog ear at the dog ear at the bottom. What is it? Dog.
I don't know now.
Now I've thrown everybody now. It's like it's like Lucy with her scissors, isn't it? Whether they're herons or they're storks. She knows full well it's a stork, but she started going on about herons the other day. So
now I don't reverse when I'm patchworking like this. I don't reverse back over the first few stitches. There's no need really because they all join together. There'll be seams over the top.
Yes.
And then quilting over the top. And so with the dog ear, the little bit of extra, it should line up.
Oh, now also, this is a point, I was about to say, oh, that one doesn't come to the top, but that's got your quarter of inch seam allowance.
That's the seam allowance.
So when you, when so here, oh, so when you stitch there, because you don't expect that point to be at the top, because that's no. got your seam allowance for when you join the lines together, the rows yes. of triangles together, isn't it?
And when I join the strips together, the rows together, I will pin through the tip of the triangle and through to the one on the other side right. to line the points, and then I will pin it just to make sure they do line up. Should I carry on and do a few more?
Oh, yes. Somebody's asking about all the rotary cutters on the table. Shall I just tell you quickly while you pin that? This is really, this is, these are three of the rotary cutters. Now, if you, I need to explain about this. If you go to the website, right, if you go to the website to buy something, if it's something you're seeing we're using live in the show, like we've just used the 45mm rotary cutters, which is the one in the middle here, you need to go, I'll just explain this to you. You need to go to the live page, right? So you need to click on the website, and you need to go to the watch and buy page, and you pop it in. I'll get Hannah to show you in a second, right? Because what you need to do, here we go, look, so you're on the website. Just here we go, look at the, again, the website. Oh, and then you press on watch the live show. Just wait, watch it. There you go, so then you get, right, so that's me a couple of seconds ago before I move my hand. Now you see to the right there, add to your basket. If it's something we're using in the show, like that book, press on add to your basket and it pops into your basket and then you check your basket out later. While we're actually on this page, just have a look here. That's the message to the studio. If you want a studio code to go straight through to Hannah, producer, that's where you can send your message there. There she is writing, hello. Be careful, Hannah, what else she writes. Right, also, if you scroll down the page, now these are, oh, there you go, these are the pieces we've shown you so far in the show today. So there's the 45mm cutters, there's the long ruler, there's the isosceles ruler, there's the Irish fat quarter, and there's the book. So you can see from a shopping list of what you're gonna, what we've used, and as the day goes on, everything that we've shown you will be on there. Now, in this instance, what I've got here is I've got three rotary cutters. We're just using the 45mm one, right? The 45mm one there, which was you saw in the graphics then. But you see, now if you want the 60mm one, or if you want the 18mm one, that's cute, isn't it? Look at that. If you want either of those, you just go to the web shop and you can still pop them in your basket. So now, Joe, I've got a quick question for you. Because you're using the 45.
Yes.
What would you use this dinky little one for?
I would use that for really intricate work. I do, I like to foundation paper piece, and that's great if you're doing a very small design, and it's really handy, much easier to use on a small, intricate item than the other sizes.
And then if you've got lots of cutting out to do, if you've got lots of big yes. squares or something to cut out, then the 60mm one here would be absolutely brilliant. Now, obviously, all of these now will be on the page for this show. Did you know you can make these right-handed and left-handed as well? They come with instructions. You can unscrew here, twist it round. You can make them right-handed or left-handed. But I hear you saying, what is that that they're all sitting on, John? Well, I haven't seen this before. It's new to me today. This is my rotary cutter holder. It's called a cradle, not a holder, John, a cradle. £9.95. Do you know what? Rather than just popping everything out, keeps them all nice and neat and tidy, doesn't it? Away from your, you know, so they're all sitting nicely on your desk like that, you see, really, really beautifully. £9.95. Sorry, I didn't mean to go off kilter there, but I just thought somebody asked what. That's how we work, you see. If you send us a question to our web chat, we'll answer it straight away. That person didn't put their name on it, but I hope that was interesting for you. Who has? Chrissy, hello, Chrissy, my love. Oh, she's addicted to the sewing quarter. She said, great, great shows. Thank you. Thank you, Chrissy, my lovely. Also, I've had lots of messages from Maureen. I didn't know. It was my friend Maureen from the Wirral, Julie's friend. You know the one. Anyway, so we're carrying on now with more triangles.
I'll just add one last one, and then press. Because I'll show, I like to then straighten up the edges with a longer ruler again and just remove the dog ears,
whatever, the bits at the end, yes. The little bits at the end. If you know the name please, please, please let us know. Now, a lot of you asking about the fabric that Joe is using. There are three fat quarters. I'll show you them in about 5 minutes. I'll show you all three of them. This is the one that she's using. It's called the Iris Bundle. And you get 8 pieces of fabric. 8 gorgeous pieces of fabric there for £9.95. I've got 2 other colourways as well, but that's the one that Jo decided to use. Okay, so moving
Shall
on.
Get the heat mat out.
Let me just hide you. Oh, well, I also forgot to tell you. Oh, I've got to stand this side of the line. I also forgot to tell you that. There we go. Your first order, if your first order is over £10, you get this. It's a free sewing kit worth £14.99. That's lovely, isn't it? I'll just unzip it for you and show you. I always worry now in case somebody's taken something out of it. Nope, that's okay. Look, you get that completely free if your first order, just on your first order, if your first order's over £10, £14.99. Right, so what are you doing now? Are you pressing to the dark side or are you pressing open?
I'm pressing open. Generally speaking, I like to press open, although there are times when pressing to one side makes life a lot easier. And
well, also because a lot of our quilters always press to the dark side. That's what we're taught. Because obviously when you make up the quilt, if you've got a white or a very pale cream and you're next to red or something, you don't want to see the seam allowance behind.
That's absolutely right. And I like the texture, actually, that you can get from pressing to one side. It just creates a bit more depth.
Okay.
But I'm pressing these open.
It's personal choice, isn't it? It's personal choice. I mean, you created something of your own, aren't you, really, here?
Yes, absolutely. And there are no rules. You just find the way that you find most convenient.
Okay.
So there we go. And I'd make several of these strips and edge, you know, finish them.
Yes. So we're kind of one of these rows across here. You've basically done it in the two colourways, but when you have the fat quarter, you've got all 8 fabrics to choose from, all the 8 different coloured fabrics to choose from.
And you could do it in stripes with 2 colours in each one. It sort of gives a bunting feel, almost.
Oh, yes, yeah. Oh, I did a bunting show the other day. It was very popular. So then, now, would you always stitch across like that then into a row before you stitch the next ones together?
Yes, I made it into rows and then I joined them into 2 rows and then I joined them. I mean, you could do it one by one. And
exactly.
It's however you...
Now, I don't want to disturb you, but a lot of you are new to us. Welcome on this Saturday morning. We've got a little film now for you to see, just about a little bit more about here at the Sewing Quarter.
Did you know there are multiple ways you can contact us, even if it's just to ask a question? Our friendly team are always on standby. You can call our customer service team at 0800 112 4433, email us at help@sewingquarter.com, visit our Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter at Sewing Quarter, and even message us through our website, and our presenters will answer your questions live on air.
When you spend £10 on your first purchase, you will receive this free sewing kit from the Sewing Quarter worth £14.99. A lot of you asking about the fabric that Jo's using. We've only actually shown one of the fat quarters so far, so I'm just going to show you the 3 varieties that are available to you. This one at the end here is the Iris one that Jo's been using. I'll just take you through it. I've ruined Amy's display now. But anyway, so that's the fat quarter that you're getting, and I'll just take you through the colours, the 8 colours you get. Now, this is the Iris one, remember. I love irises. I love them in spring, really. So you get that fabulous turquoise. Then you do beautiful deep navy. Then that's what I would call iris. That purple is what I would call iris itself. Then there's kind of a crushed damson there, isn't it? That's a really lovely colour. Then there's a kind of a great... These would be fantastic. If you haven't got a project actually in mind for them, these would be fantastic for your stash because all these colours... Really, that's what I'd call a kind of duck egg blue there. And then you've got a sky blue underneath. And then you've got your white. So, again, really, really lovely fat quarter there of all the different colours. So that one there is the iris. That's the iris, right? So which colour would you like me to go to next then, Hannah? Rose, which is... Oh, hang on, she's just named it Rose. I'll just double check which one she's gone to. This one. Here we go. This is Rose. This is called Rose. Again, I love the colours in this one. Look at those gorgeous colours there. I'll take you through them all. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic colours. £9.95. Just add it to your order. You can, and now if you don't want to put it in your basket on the web, you can just ring the call centre, 0800 112 4433, remember. Really, really lovely. So, the colours in the rose are, well, they're all rose colours, aren't they? That's a really gorgeous, like, crushed raspberry colour, that one. Beautiful, vivid fuchsia. I'm saying the roses, but that's a fuchsia colour there, isn't it? That's lovely. That's, I think there's a rose my mum and dad used to grow when I was little, called Superstar, and that's a colour there. That's a really lovely, like a baby pink, bubblegummy baby pink there. Then we jump to the kind of dark biscuit, oatmeal biscuit, that one's really lovely colour. Now, it's funny, isn't it? You say that, if you went into a shop and you saw that fabric on a roll, you go, ooh, I don't want that brown. But actually, it's a really, really lovely colour, especially when you team it with all these colours. Because then you've got your clotted cream, or is that more like your buttermilk? Maybe that's a buttermilk, that one there, because that one's more clotted cream ivory, isn't it? And then again, at the bottom of that one, you've got your staple white. So that one there is your rose bundle for £9.95. And then the last but not least, this one is called Winterberries. Winterberries. I knew that one, didn't I? Didn't know the rose, but I knew the Winterberries. This is nice. Now, we love the colours. We love the colours. That's the Winterberry Fat Quarter, £9.95. But the colours are gorgeous. I'll just take you through them. We've got this top one here, which is like a flame, like an orangey-red flame, that one. Then I've got a vibrant peach. Or is that an apricot? I always get confused between my peaches and my apricots. Hang on. Are they apricots orange? But apricot colour. I'd say that was apricot though. In the shop, I'd say that one was called apricot. Then we got that lovely peach. I'd call that one peach. Then beautiful, beautiful yellow. Mimosa yellow, that isn't it? That's a gorgeous mimosa yellow there. Then we've got like a fabulous spring green. Remember, you get all of these in the pack. You get all of these in the Winter Bay pack, the spring green. Then I'd say that one was,
Sorrel?
Come on, Jo, help me.
Sorrel?
Who?
Sorrel, is that...
Do you know Laurel? Oh, no, Laurel. I thought you met my friend Laurel. So I didn't know you knew Laurel. And then there's this one here, which is a really beautiful...
Oh, I don't know, I'm terrible with names.
Forest. I'd say maybe that one was forest. And then that one there, which is a really like grass, dark green grass green. That is the Winterberry. That's the Winterberry one there. It's fantastic. Now, while I'm here, I know Joe's waiting. I know you want to see the demonstration carried on. And I promise I'll go back and we'll get a full demonstration from Joe. Lots of people asking about the book. So I'll just tidy this up so I can show you. Look at me. It's like I'm in a shop here, isn't it? Okay, which one do you want to look at? This one here, All Things Quilting, is the one you want to look at. It's a fabulous, fabulous book, look. Really, really lovely. All Things Quilting by Alex Anderson. The First Step to the Last Stitch. £19.95. I won't take as long. It's got everything. Very basic techniques right the way through to complicated quilts in there. And it's just gorgeous. And it's also be lovely as a coffee table book, that one, because it's just the colour, it's uplifting and up, you know, I love it. £19.95. Give the call centre a ring or put one in your basket. You do have to check out your basket by midnight though. Okay, so have a look at that book while I just pop back now over to Joe.
Okay.
So, what's the next stage we're going to show then?
Little tip, before you join...
Oh, a little tip, everybody, from Jo.
I like to neaten the edges before I join the strips together.
Yes.
Just to remove these little bits. But on this ruler, you have the quarter inch mark running all along.
Right, yeah.
So I would line that up with the points of the triangles. So you've definitely got the right seam allowances.
Yes. It always looks better when you're working. Doesn't it always look better as you tidy as you go along? Because otherwise you get to the end and there's threads and everything all over the place. Whereas that's going to be lovely and neat and tidy to work with.
So neatening both sides, it just makes it easier to line up. And it neatens it all off.
So you'd make a row of the width of almost your final piece, ending up with the, always like you've done there, ending up with the yep. half triangle at the end there. Just carry on this then at the other end, put the other half triangle, so you've got a complete strip to sew together to do that.
That's right.
Okay. What are you going to show me next then?
Should I do some diamonds?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, so you can do this. So if you wanted to do a could you mix the diamonds and the triangles together? That might be a question for later. Show me how to do diamonds.
You could.
I can.
You could.
Thank you.
I'll leave it there, though, just in case I confuse myself.
Okay. Now, the long ruler that you've been using, Hannah's intrigued by the long ruler, because she said because you're a toy designer, for people who don't know, you're a soft toy designer.
I am, primarily, yes.
You use this one an awful lot when you're doing, because it's not just for quilting, you use it for a lot for your, when you're doing your soft toys and things, don't you?
I use it for all sorts. I really use the square one as well. Oh, it's over there. That's great for toys as well. I use that, I made a cat on a show earlier on and used that one a lot.
You mean the cat that I'm taking home?
Yes, that one.
It's still on the shelf next door, I haven't told them yet. This one here is the So Easy Patchwork Rule 61 by 16 centimetres, 24 by 6.5 inches. Everybody that we use, all our experts have said that they use that one. That's the first one they ever bought. And then the second one that they bought was the square one here. Let me take that one out so it doesn't confuse you. There's the square one there. At £13 at 95 pence, 25 by 20. Could I stand behind it more so my belly shows off the markings? And one of my emails this week was very nice. It was like, oh, it's lovely to see you standing up on telly, John. We didn't know you had a belly. I was like, that's nice. That's nice, isn't it? Right, somebody's just texting saying they like my buttons. Thank you very much indeed. Right, diamonds. Are they...
Just another about these rulers.
Oh, about the rulers, yes.
Mention.
No, it's good. We'll get all the tips out.
They work really well together if you're squaring up a quilt. Because at the end, when you quilt, the wadding, the batting, is wider all the way around. So you need to trim that off and the backing fabric to get a neat edge to add your binding
yes.
to. And butting them up together like that in the corner, so you can make sure it's straight.
So you're not just doing a little corner like that, you can do the whole sweep of the corner
yes,
at the same
they're
time.
Brilliant as a combined
yes,
to do that.
As a pair, but you need a bigger cutting board for
you would need a larger one.
Okay, lovely. Right, so moving on to diamonds now. Are diamonds more difficult then?
They can be quite difficult to match the points up. That's the quite intricate to piece together.
Oh, but they look gorgeous.
But there's so much you can do with diamonds. You could do them, cut diamonds that size and piece them like that.
Okay, you've gone for much smaller. Oh, look, that looks fantastic. I watched the, what's that Pottery Throwdown show last night? It was on. I love it. And, one of the boys in that, it's so funny, he's a model in real life and he gets so many close-ups and the lady judge is obviously completely in love with him. But he did a clock like this and I love this kind of, it's almost like a sunburst, I don't know what the pattern is actually called, but it's like an explosion from the middle outwards and you could do all the colours you've used would just burst from that centre point. Now that looks terribly complicated because I'm sure the points here must be really difficult to match up with.
They are quite tricky, but again, I use a pin, and we'll put a pin through where the point would be on the seam allowance.
Yes.
And do that on the side I'm joining it to.
Oh, I see.
And pin them like that.
And would you ever tack? Would you ever tack them, or would you just put the pin through and?
I just pin and then sew, but they can be quite tricky. But I have a mini quilt like this above my bed as a wall hanging in my room. Oh. But I love this design.
Producer Hannah is intrigued by your house. And when you put a picture on Instagram, they've asked, oh, Joe's put this. And she went, is it a fabulous house? And I went, all I can see is a carpet. All I can see is a carpet and a leg. That's all I can see. It was after a long day here. She was just relaxing. Let me just explain about these pins that Joe was just using. They're really lovely. Now, these are quilters glass-headed pins. So the pins themselves are actually longer and they've got the glass head on the top. So first of all, you can see them. Secondly, it's no worry if you iron over
them. Catch one with an iron. It's fine.
Yes, because Anna's convinced, though, that your house is full of all colourful, crazy little soft toys. That's what, in her brain, that's what she's got.
It is, but it's also full of mess.
Full of mess. We couldn't see the mess, just very clean.
No, I'm very careful with my photographs not to reveal the state.
Right. Are you going to show us how to cut these out now using the rulers? Is that what you're doing?
Yes.
Now, I love that.
Diamonds are much easier to cut out than you would think.
Oh, are they?
If I take that one again. So I've already straightened up the edge of this one. Now these diamonds are I think 2.5.
Now, Hannah's saying, I'm going to stop talking about Hannah in a minute. She's just, it's Saturday morning, she's still very like that, you know. She wants to do this and make a floor cushion out of it.
That would look beautiful.
Wasn't it?
Yes. Ooh, now I quite fancy making one.
Oh,
those.
Well, there we go. That could be your next project then.
Hang on, it's not as straight as I thought.
Get Hannah to make you one. She said, no, she'll be too busy making her own. So, you're straightening off your edges again.
Straighten that edge.
So if you use, do you always put your fabric on the fold when you're doing quilting?
Often.
Yes.
It just makes it a bit easier and you don't have, you're not stretching
for
as long.
Yeah, of course, yes. And also you're getting two, if you're cutting out, you get automatically get two straight away, don't you, of the same. If you want multiples of everything, it's folded, you get two, you know.
Yes. Me. I'll cut some, let's do some 2-inch.
So if you
cut a strip, slightly smaller than those ones.
So how big are the ones we've got in the on the table here then?
These are 2.5. The distance, because I cut them in a strip, so it was a 2.5-inch strip, and then I cut.
Okay. Oh, so you've started those off the same as these then, but you're making slightly smaller ones now.
I am. There's my triangular ruler. So,
right, triangle ruler coming out now.
Also good to mitre for binding. Because it's 45 degrees.
Okay, so even though you've got your 45 degrees on the other rulers as well, this one's quite a good one because it's all the side is automatically 45 degrees.
I'm not going to cut towards you, John. There we go.
Okay.
And because the strip is 2 inches wide, yes. Almost forgot then, you just carry on then using... 2-inch mark.
I'm intrigued. Can we see this? Because I'm a bit intrigued by what you're doing here. Let me just put that. I'm worried that the
mat's
going to fall off the edge of the table. So you've taken that. That was the angle that you've just cut off there. So that was your strip. So you've cut that 45 degree angle off the end. Now what are you lining up then?
Because this is 2 inches wide, we want 2 inches that way.
Okay.
So I'd use the square one along there, like that.
Oh!
To cut out. Some diamonds.
And oh wow.
And again, like with the triangles, you can cut multiple diamonds at a time.
Now this one you wouldn't be able to cut them, like I was saying earlier, you could cut on the fold, you get two of everything, but you couldn't really do this on the fold because
because if there was a print that would run this way,
yes,
it would be on the angle yes. on your diamond, which actually when in a star shape like this, it almost flows round, it almost spins round
oh, okay.
in a circular
yeah,
way,
yeah,
so
yeah,
it can
yeah.
create a really yeah. nice design and shape. But you could fold the fabric over and use
oh,
your triangle.
Oh, we're getting complicated now. So.
I know. And cut your diamonds like that along.
Oh, so the I fold. See. So then you get then you get the pattern going down the diamond.
Yes, then yes. it'd be up and down. And then I've pieced these together. I actually. Once I'd cut the strips, before cutting them out, I seamed the strips together and then cut along. So I had already sewn them together in a 3. And then just pieced them together into triangles. Now, the thing with this ruler, move that one out of the way. If you wanted to straighten the edges off.
Right, can I ask a question? I don't
Go
know,
on.
I'm not sure where you're going next. It's fine, we've got 10 minutes left yet. So would you make panels this shape and then stitch them all together into the centre. You've made eight of those. Yeah, eight
yes.
of those. What would if you would if like because I'm just trying to give ideas at home, especially help for Hannah when she starts making her floor cushion. So once you've made this, would you then stitch these together? Is that the next stage?
Yes, you want to with patchwork. You want to get it into the easiest shape possible. So I would stitch them together in pairs and then you have a right angle.
Oh, yes. So you'd make four right angles.
Yes, and then I'd sew them together like that.
And how far would you get, like, if that was your, if this is going to be your finished size, would you wait until you've got to your finished size before you started sewing them together? Or maybe you put, if you're doing a quilt, you're going to have 1 starburst, 2 starburst, 3 starburst, 4 starburst. Would you make each starburst up and then put them all together?
Yes, I do it that way.
Can you show us then, I know I'm putting you on the spot here, but if you sewed that one to that one, how you know your points are going to get to the same place? Because you've mentioned about putting the pin in. Be nice if we actually do it. And I know we didn't rehearse this, but...
It's guaranteed not to match up. Because
oh, no, no, it will. It will.
Just do it that way. The pins. So I would bring a pin through at about the point on the seam allowance that the tip of the diamond should reach. If I put it through and then pulled it out again. There.
Okay.
And then I'd do the same on that one. So I pop it through there like that. I moved them and confused myself. And it just helps.
Oh, I was going to say, how are you going to stitch that? So literally you're just putting the pin through to hold them both in the same place, but then you'd just put a pin in to hold it. You wouldn't leave that pin in while you were sewing.
No,
it was just literally a guide.
There we go. So push that in so that they line up and then pop another pin in.
And then take the guide one out. And then you know that they're in the right place then to match up.
Hopefully.
Well, yeah, I'm not going to make you sew it now.
Shall I sew it and
Go on then, if you want to.
I'll be brave.
Go on and be brave. Joe's just using the Iris 8-piece fat quarter bundler for £9.95. There are the two other colourways as well, which I'll take you through in a few minutes. And then the pins that she's using there, £3.95. Pop them in your basket. So somebody's asked, do I make my own shirts? Not anymore. I used to make my own shirts, but I get all my... now I've got a lovely friend who's a designer called Claudio Lugli, who makes all these shirts. They're beautiful. I think now I'm back here, maybe... No, not from Hollywood, from North London. I may start making them myself again. I also have to say to you, if you're having issues with the sound on the web, it's been sorted. It's been sorted now. Right. Moment of truth. Like, oh my word! Perfect, perfect. So that's a fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. Yeah. Now Hannah's saying, could you make a floor cushion for her? Because she knows she won't get it. But Hannah, everyone will know that when they get to your house, everything's higgledy-piggledy anyway, so it'll match in with higgledy-piggledy. What were you going to say? Sorry, before I rudely interrupted you there, what were you going to say about the edges there?
If you wanted to leave it like that. Now, to straighten the edges, you could... I'll do it on this one.
It's your religion. Oh, that square ruler.
And trim away the excess triangle... to turn them into triangles,
yes.
Trim away the excess at the top.
That's not like you know to waste anything, is it?
It's not, really. I would be inclined to... this ruler...
Right.
If you... This isn't the right size triangle.
Yes.
But you could measure out... Where the points, that's about the centre. You could add on a quarter an inch, mark it with some tape, and then cut out triangles.
So rather than cut off there, which is you're saying, you'd then make triangles to fit in there, so your finished edge would be that far. I suppose it depends on how big you're making your quilt and how much colour you want, because that would, I mean, I know this is a different size, but that would look lovely in there. With a triangle,
it would.
Could give it a frame, wouldn't it?
A lovely board, yeah. But this... I quite like things like this in the centre of a table. You could just make a small quilted piece to go in the centre of your dining table.
Oh, that'd be nice. The thing is, we're showing you how to do quilting like this. Like, quilting is such a personal thing. You can make whatever you want. You could make a baby cot quilt out of this, couldn't you? Because it's lovely, soft fabric. As you say, you can make a table runner like this. You can make a central piece. What shape's the one on the wall behind your bed, then?
I've squared that off. So it's a square quilt, and I think it has... maybe 5 rows of diamonds on it.
Well, could you bring a picture in next time?
Okay.
All right, then. Well, and also, if you've got any pictures that you want to share with us, it's so easy. It's so easy to get in touch. Right, so we've gone through diamonds, we've gone through triangles. Now, I notice on this one, then, let's just go back to this. So you've sewn all your strips together.
Yes.
Then you've put some wadding and a backing fabric behind it. And then did you... if you stitched that, where would you start? Because I notice you followed, but there's like a little crossover where all the points come together. Where would you start stitching that?
When quilting, it's always best to start in the middle and work out
right
all the way around, just to make sure the fabric is being sort of stretched out evenly all the way across.
So if this was your... So imagine there were no stitches in here at all, and this was your finished piece. Where would you put your needle in to start?
To start, I think it would have been somewhere
and
around here, I think. And I would begin there and stitch out to the end and then do the other side to it and work out that way.
Oh, okay.
And then as these lines filled in, I'd start adding the cross ones. And I've noticed I've missed this one out.
Oh, was that on? Oh, yes.
No, I've only noticed as we've been live.
You missed both sides?
I have, not just the one side.
Oh, there's one here.
See, that's quilting.
Not that I'm picking out your faults or anything, because I wouldn't even be able to get that far. Oh!
Oh,
was it late when you finished this one? I think it's gorgeous. Anyway, I love the colours. I love all those iris colours.
Beautiful and rich,
really rich colours there, aren't they? Oh, that's the fat course you see there. So, should we just run through everything you use tool-wise? Because this is all about setting up your quilting room, isn't it? And giving you little tips. So, when we started with... the long ruler, didn't we? So this is an essential for everybody's quilting kit.
I didn't have one of these for a while, and I really struggled. I noticed the difference hugely once I got one of these, because you use it for everything.
But as you say, you don't just use it for your quilting, you use it for everything now, for your toy, soft toy making and everything.
If I was making curtains, I'd use that to straighten up the edges.
Oh, wow.
But, yes.
You don't even think about things like that, do you? This is £15.95. It's a so-easy patchwork rule, 61 by 16 centimetres. For those of you who work in inches like me, 24 by 6.5. Now, remember, no matter how many pieces you buy during a day, you still only pay one P&P of £2.95. So that was the long ruler we start with. Then we move to the square ruler, which is the 10 inches by 10 inches, 25 centimetres square. Another essential, really. Another one that all our experts use a lot of, isn't it?
Yes. Great for linings, for bags, and yes, I use that one a lot.
And also, at £13.95, this one, you also said about if you've got a wide, like when you're squaring off the corner of a quilt and thing, if you joint work those together,
yes,
then you create a very big L-shaped corner.
It's really
don't you?
Helpful to get that corner right.
So you see, you run along the bottom of your quilt and down the side of your quilt there, creating a very, very good corner. Right, then we moved on to the isosceles triangle. I haven't seen this one so far. Apart from in rehearsals, I haven't seen this one on a live show yet. Don't see this one as often, but if you do diamonds and triangles, it's kind of essential, isn't it? Well, no, it's not essential, but it helps, doesn't it?
It speeds everything up, and it'd be great for bunting.
Oh yes.
I think if you cut out that exact shape, that'd be perfect to make bunting flags.
Oh, I know, it was somebody on the radio the other day saying they were making bunting for their daughter's wedding, which is in July or something. I was thinking, that's going to... But then, if they're doing it as a project. Then we're moving on to the rotary cutters. Oh, sorry, was that all you wanted to go, Hannah? Oh, OK, then. So this, I'll just put them in here. So we've got different sized rotary cutters here in a rotary cradle. So the... OK, I've got to be quick with this. I'll run through. This is the 18mm, this is the 45mm, and that's the 60mm. And then the cradle, £9.95 for your cradle there. Always go, look at the website for the cutting mat as well. Because I need to show you all the fabrics that are available, the three fat quarters that are available in this hour. Do you want me to go over, or would you like me to show you here, Hannah? I'll go over. In an hour.
I'll be back.
To make?
Some coasters and a sunglasses case, some little projects.
Fantastic. Oh, don't go. Oh, no, you can go now.
You can go now.
You come with me, because we're going to go through... Oh, and the book. Everyone's going crazy about this book. So, first of all, we've got the three fat quarters here. Really, really lovely. So, this is the iris one here. And you get those gorgeous colours in there.
Really, everyone's loving this one. Everybody's loving the colours in this one. This is the Iris 8-piece fat quarter for £9.95. Next one. Rose. This is the rose. Now, these are all those lovely, lovely, luscious rose colours there, and raspberries and pinks and creams and lemons in there. £9.95 for the rose 8-piece fat quarter bundle. You know what? These, if you've not got a project lined up, then all of these colours would be amazing for your stash, wouldn't they? We call it your stash. You know, just that the boxes of fabric you've got in the other room. Because you never know. But because we're going to be doing, in a minute, we're going to do a cot quilt. If you wanted a stash for the back of the cot quilt, these would be perfect, wouldn't they? Then, winter berry. Now, these are luscious colours. I think they're more, personally, I'd say it was more of a spring berry look, this, myself. But you get the really, really vibrant colours in there. You get the lemons in there. You get the greens in there. And the lovely forest and leaf greens at the bottom there. Again, that's the winter berry fat quarter, £9.95. All you have to do is dial the number 0800 112 4433 or go to www.sewingquarter.com. There's this book as well, this beautiful book. We will have it in all the other shows today as well. Fabulous book there, All Things Quilting by Alex Anderson. That is £19.95. It'll be out all day, and I've got another book to show you as well later on. Right, don't go anywhere, because we've got Angie coming up next, and we're some lovely fabrics in the next show. We're making a baby cot quilt. Don't go anywhere. You've literally got 3 minutes to get yourself a cup of tea, and I'll be back here with Angie. See you then.
The Sewing Quarter is a new, inspirational sewing and quilting channel here to help educate our viewers with some of the best designers in the business. We hope to bring you some exciting demonstrations with some of the top industry experts. We're part of the Immediate Media family. Immediate Media is a fast-growing multi-platform company who operate some of the most loved brands across the UK. Our brands range from our first TV shopping channel adventure with Jewellery Maker to several successful magazines such as Simply Sewing, Radio Times, BBC Good Food and many more. We've been working incredibly hard to set up and bring you our new exciting channel, and we hope that we can help inspire you with new ideas and projects. Here at the Sewing Quarter, we sell fabric in all sorts of different sizes. Some will be pre-cut, but others will be specifically cut to your order. The most common measurement you'll hear us talk about here at the Sewing Quarter is your fat quarter. So the fat quarter is 22 inches across and 20 inches there. Now that's 55 centimetres by 50 centimetres approximately there. Now fat quarters will often be sold in bundles for you, and they come looking beautiful, all lovely and folded, and it's great for storage because it doesn't look as though you've got as much fabric as you're actually getting. Lots of people prefer fat quarters to long quarters because you can cut larger pieces from your fat quarter. So this is a long quarter, and your long quarter is cut across the bolt, so it's edge to edge crossways. That is your salvage edge to edge. So we're looking at 110 centimeters across. For those of you that like your inches, that's 44 inches, and it's 25 centimetres deep, so that's what, 10 inches. So if you're looking at cutting your 2.5-inch strips, that's absolutely perfect. You'll get 4 of those out of a long quarter. So you can clearly see the difference between a fat quarter and the long quarter. So this is your half metre. So the half metre is salvage to salvage, so that's 110 centimetres or 44 inches. And then it's your half metre in width there. So that's going to be 50 centimetres or your 20 inches there. Now this is double a fat quarter, so if you have a fat quarter, it's going to be half this, and it would just be cut down the middle there, and that would give you 2 fat quarters. It's getting bigger now. We're on to your metre. Here we go. So this is your meter of fabric. So again, edge to edge crossways, that is your salvage. So that's 110 centimeters or 44 inches. And then this length here, that's your meter or 40 inches.
But of course, here at the Sewing Quarter, we cut your fabric from half metre increments so you can buy as much as you like. Check out our website for more details.
Welcome back, welcome back. Isn't this beautiful? Isn't this completely gorgeous? It's a baby cot quilt made by my next guest, Angie, who you all know and you all love, but you know what? Who arrived an hour early this morning. That's how eager she is. isn't it lovely? Absolutely gorgeous. Now, what I'm going to do is we're going to show you how to make this in this next hour. It's quilted. It's just beautiful. But I've got lots of fabrics to show you. So before we go over and meet Angie, I'm going to take you through all the different fabrics. Because the actual quilt is made from a panel. I've got two panels to show you today. So I'll just put this back because I'll take that back over with me in a second. So the two panels, now I need to take the panel out to show you what you're actually getting for your money. So this is the panel. This is what you'll be getting as a panel. This is the one that Angie's going to be using and has used. That's gorgeous then. Now, we don't sell this by the half metre. This actually comes as a... Oh, look at that selvage there. Isn't that lovely? This actually comes as a panel. Now, it's 60 centimetres by 112 centimetres. I will just double check for you now. I love the colours. I love the fabrics. It's by Makawa, obviously, so you know the quality is just amazing. Now, the thing is, we've used it as a panel and kept it whole, but if you wanted to, you could chop all those bits and bobs up, couldn't you? Make your own patchwork out of that. Really, really lovely, isn't it? So that's the jungle print. The graphics will come in a second. They've just got a few issues. Here we go. There you go. The Makawa Baby Jungle Panel. Now, as Angie said earlier while we were prepping, if you wanted a wider piece, if you wanted to make not a baby cot quilt out of it, but like a toddler's quilt or anything a little bit bigger, you can buy several panels. They don't come all individually cut. They'll come joined together. So if you wanted to make a square, you could buy two together. Do you know what I mean? If you want to make a throw for the nursery or a changing mat or something like that, you could get two of them if you wanted to. Do you know what I mean? So that comes as the panel for £6.95. But not only have I got that panel, I've got another... Can I also just point out something here? I love this about Makawa fabrics. On the selvage here, on that selvage... Look at... You see the colours? Now, the numbers aren't significant to anything. They're just how many colours there are on that panel. But if you want to match up fabric, or if you want to match up thread, you see all those numbers across the bottom there? They're all the colours that they've used. So if you wanted to match it up with anything, then you could just match up with those. It's a fantastic idea, even to your top stitching detailing, right? Even to your top stitching detailing. So that's one panel. Then I've got another panel to show you. This is lovely. This is really... Don't worry, we will be getting on to Angie in a minute. I just need to show you all the fabrics first. This... Is this right? Yes? That's the other panel. There's two panels here. They've sent me two panels here. That's really, really lovely, isn't it? Look at that. Isn't that lovely? Really, really gorgeous. Oh, sorry, I've just lifted up there too quickly. All those, they're like little stamps, aren't they? Really gorgeous, gorgeous print there. All the different animals you're getting there. Right, that also, that's called the what, Hannah? The block. Oh, there it is. The block fabric panel by Makawa. It's really, really gorgeous, really stunning. I love it. And also the quality of this fabric is just beautiful. It's really, really lovely. Now, very quickly, I'll just show you the fabrics now, excuse me, that they've teamed up with these two panels. Now, shall I follow you or will you follow me? Okay, we've got the blue with triangles first, which is a really, really... Now, obviously, you could use these for so many other different projects. We're just showing you... These sell in half-metre increments, remember? This is lovely. So if you're buying on the web, half a metre is one unit. So if you want 2 metres, you buy 4 units. A lot of our viewers are ringing in to the call centre and saying, oh, I need 4 metres, and then the call centre is sorting it out for them. But that is lovely, isn't that? Beautiful, beautiful. It's kind of a powder blue... with all the different colours, the beautiful Makawa colours all going over there. Use it for all sorts of things, cushion covers, anything you like, really, but it's a really, really lovely fabric. Graphics just coming in.
Oh, well, there you go. Traffic's triangle. Triangle on blue fabric. Now, that's £5.45 for half a metre. £5.45 for half a metre. That's really, really lovely. And then moving down here, I've got the alphabet. I want to call it alphabet spaghetti, but it's not spaghetti. It's just the alphabet. Really lovely for a children's nursery, a children's playroom. So not only just to make the quilt, but you could also make cushions out of that, wall hangings out of that. And then as they're learning about letters and everything, it's a really good, educational as well as fun, isn't it? That's £5.45. You can make, now the other day with Lucy, I made like a lovely drawstring top bag, you know, like to put their pumps in or their PE kit or anything like that, at £5.45 for half a metre. I've also got the elephant fabric here. I promise I'll get on with the expert. I just want you to have a look at all of these beautiful fabrics before we start. This is the elephant. This is the elephant fabric, this one. Now, that's what Angie's used as her backing for her panel for her baby cot quilt. That is the Makoa elephants on blue background. Well, it's what it says on the tin, isn't it? Elephants on blue background. £5.45. Now, it doesn't matter. If you're making something for a newborn baby, that, you know what I mean? It's not that, oh, is it pink, is it blue? We could just use all the gorgeous colours there. Ring the call centre if you're confused, but we do sell in half-metre increments. Then, last but not least, in that range, we've got the chalk stripe. Now, I love this. Now, this could be for a grown-up room as well. The chalk stripe could be for a grown-up room as well. Really, really lovely, isn't it? The fabulous stripes on there. There we go. Look at the colours. It's the same colours that you used to. So all of these tone in beautifully with each other. It does look like they're hand-drawn. That's because it's a chalk stripe fabric for half a metre. £5.45. Really lovely. And then now Hannah's chosen some fabrics as well that she thinks go beautifully with all of this. So, and let me just take that one off there because I'll let Amy tidy up in a second. You can see these four other fabrics. Now, they're called linear. These are called linear, that's right, isn't it? Linear fabrics, these. Love the colours. Absolutely love the colours. I'll just run through the colours very quickly. This one, the first one, duck egg. This one's the duck egg. Now, I need to warn you, it's more of a pale grey than a duck egg. It's more of a pale grey. But look at the fabric. Look at the pattern on the fabric. £4.95 for half a metre. So that's the duck egg there. And then the mustard, which is next to it here, is £4.95. You can see it just there. They're £4.95. So that's the duck egg and the mustard. And then if we just drop down to the two other colours here, and then I'll go over to Angie. She's sitting there yawning at me now. These look beautiful. These look so beautiful together. So now that's the teal across the bottom. That's the teal one running across the bottom. Don't get confused, that's duck egg. That's the teal, right? That's the teal on that side, which is that graphic there. And then there's the orange one there again. If you have any confusion, just ring the call centre and they'll be able to help you out with anything. Okay, I'll run through it all again with you later. I know it's a lot to take in. Hello, you.
Good morning,
Mrs. Stripey Top. How are you?
I love your collar.
Thank you. it goes nice. I go nice with this, don't I? I love this. I absolutely love this.
Just listening to you, I was going to say the colours are very non-gender specific as well, aren't they?
Yes, exactly. If you're making it before the baby's born or they haven't said what sex it is, then that's brilliant. Yeah. So how do you start?
Okay, so the panels are a great start for people that are beginning with quilting.
Oh, okay.
So there's no piecing involved, no patchwork involved. So they're really great if you're just starting on your quilting journey. And so this project's great for you to learn the process of actually putting a small quilt together. So as you said, the top comes all in one piece.
Yes.
And it's a specific size. So then what we need to do is go about layering. And you've got your panel, choose your backing fabric, and then your wadding.
You do this straight away.
Yeah.
Now, people are asking what size the baby, the panel is.
Okay.
I could measure it for you. I've got to take measure there, Amy. Oh, it is. It's 60 by 120. It's just not. It's 60 centimetres across, but it's 120 drop there. Anyway, that's fine. That's good. Before you do that, like I said over there, if you were a more experienced quilter and you wanted to create your own look, you could cut all of these out, couldn't you? And use, because they've got enough room around them to seam allowance and whatever you want. You know what I mean? You could.
When I was making this, actually, what dawned on me would be nice is to choose one of your other plain fabrics and cut these out.
It's a family. It's our plain fabrics.
And make a little on the back of the door with pockets.
Oh, a storage, like a nursery tiny sort of thing.
Yes. So you could make all these into individual pockets on another background and keep all your baby cream.
Yeah. What I love as well, is apart from it being gorgeous, it's education as well. Yeah. You've got one giraffe.
Yeah, you have. Number two is really difficult to find.
Oh, two zebras. I tell you what, sorry. Monkeys are three. Oh, they're not doing very well, sir. Oh, four elephants.
It's upside down.
Yes, yes. Five lions. I've got five lions. Six tigers. Seven. Anyway, so that is seven pelicans or toucans, are they? Eight other cats.
There you go.
There must be a nine somewhere. So nine monkeys. Anyway, that's a lesson over and done with. So you put... Oh, they're all taking the mickey out of me now. So you get your panel.
Yes.
You get your wadding. And then you get... You've chosen this gorgeous backing fabric here. But you just choose... And you make a sandwich out of all of it.
What's ideally, if you've got a nice table you can lay this out on, tape your background fabric down. Just with some masking tape or something.
Not to the table?
To the table, so that it doesn't move.
Right.
Then lay your wadding. Because as you try, it's a bit sort of... I mean, I've used some basting spray on this, which I'll come on to.
Yeah.
But it's quite strange stuff, wadding. And the minute you get it near fabric, it wants to cling and move.
Oh, well, so it's like a magnet. It's like when you put two magnets together.
It's a bit Velcro-y. Yes, yeah. So if you tape your base fabric right side down, obviously.
Yes.
Tape that down so it's not going to move. Then lay your wadding and then lay your top. And you can see they're getting slightly larger.
Yes.
So you can see where you are. So that's your starting point.
So what do you do after you've put them... So this one's still taped to the table with masking tape.
Yes.
This one and this one. Have you stuck them together or are you going to baste
them? Lay them nice and straight, you know, first with no creases in. Then you can choose to either hand baste them with just huge tacking stitches. Or if you're in a hurry or you don't like hand tacking, this repositional spray glue is excellent.
Okay.
It doesn't clog up your sewing machine.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, so that's really nice to know. So then what you can do then, you see you can peel half of the fabric back, spray one half, fold it back and smooth it out, do the other side, just let that settle a bit, and then you can, you can do that from the base.
Yes.
You know, with your two layers. So that's how you'd either spray it down or hand baste it, however you're comfortable, and then you're ready to start quilting.
Okay, I'll just show this because a lot of people have never heard of this. This is fantastic. So you spray it on, that's like a hairspray almost, isn't it? But you can reposition. So once you've put something down, because I'd be terrified that you put it on, put your fabric down, it's also not in the right place, but you can lift it and re-put it back down again. That's £7.95. And that'll last you for ages, wouldn't you? Because you only need a thin...
Yes, and when I was using it initially, I thought I'd always got to go outside to do it, but it's not actually. I use it in my studio at home, and it's not... it doesn't get everywhere like a normal spray adhesives do. So when you're ready to start quilting, I think I heard Jo say actually when you should start quilting, we always start from the centre of any piece of work and try and work out. So I've put a few quilting lines already in here.
Of course.
I'd start with a big cross. This panel's great because you were just going between the squares actually. And they're a bit sort of, they're not exactly straight lines either, so I just keep the foot in the middle of the tram lines almost.
Now, I noticed that you've used the white on the white fabric.
Yes, like an off-white cream,
But your bobbin thread is the navy to match the elephant fabric.
Just to
would go you always in. Would you always do matching or could you do contrasting?
You could do contrasting, if that's the kind of look that you're looking for. You can use a contrasting thread. But usually with quilting, you get it to sort of blend in, and it's to give the pattern, really, rather than seeing the stitches.
Right. So you say you'd start here and you go across, so you do the big cross in the middle first.
Yes, and then I've started to work out from there
a
bit at a time. So I've got left here a few pieces to do, so I can do that. I've got a few areas still to quilt. And you can quilt as little or as... You know, as much as you like. On this one, the finished one, I've gone between even the smaller.
I was going to say, because you could, if you wanted to make it more.
Which I've done
on the finished
one,
I'll just show you here.
Can you see that?
And he's gone in between the little pictures as well there,
and
in between
on the
rectangle ones there. But on this one, you haven't so far.
No.
But it's up to you, isn't it?
How
does, if there are more stitches you do, does it make it more quilt-likey, cosy-y for the baby?
Actually, the more that you quilt, the stiffer Right. Normally a quilt will go, and obviously then you're going to lose some of that loftiness. So you don't want to quilt it to until it's like a piece of cardboard. Don't get too mad.
Right, now, have you got any tips? Because, this is only a small quilt, but when you get to your machine, it could be quite bulky, couldn't it?
Yes. First thing is, if you haven't got one already for your machine, a walking foot is invaluable.
Okay.
This is this huge contraption of a foot that you can... Can we see that on there?
Can you normally... It's a very odd looking foot. Can you buy... If your machine hasn't got one, can you go to your... supplier.
Absolutely.
And buy a walking foot. It's called a walking foot.
A walking foot or an even feed foot.
Right, and what does that do?
So your feed dogs that are here on the base, on the needle plate of your machine, they're what, when you're normally stitching, they are what feed the fabric through in a straight line, those spiky teeth under there.
Okay, so the feed dogs are the ones that
in
usually
the
take the fabric through. Yeah. Have you done something to those?
No, they're just set normally, but when you've got layers of fabric, I don't know if you've ever turned a pair of curtains up.
No.
So if you turn, you know, if you're turning anything up, but you've got your hem, and then by the time you've got to the end, you've got a lot of shift.
Yes.
And so that's what happens with layers. And so what the walking foot has, I don't know if you'll be able to see actually, it has another set of feet there.
Oh, yes, yes,
I don't
know
if you can see those, if I can just point to them.
So I point it from this side. If you just move your hand down. Yep. So am I pointing in the right place?
Yes. Yeah, they're just there.
Okay, so that's, what, an extra foot?
So it's another set of feed dogs that are on the top.
Oh, I see.
So what it's going to do is grab the top and the bottom layer and feed them even feed.
Evenly.
Yeah,
evenly
that's why some people call it an even feed foot.
Oh, yes, so, that would be right then.
But it's not just great for quilting. Any time you've got any hem or any several layers of fabric, they're just invaluable. They're quite an expensive foot, but it's a good investment.
But if you're going to take up quilting as a hobby, then you're going to use it a lot,
aren't you? You're going to use it a lot. And the other thing to do is just increase your stitch length.
Okay.
Just to help it chug along nicely. You don't want to be doing, and it looks, you know, the visual effect of a larger stitch is
but
really
you
nice
haven't gone as big as a gather. I'm going to move all this because I'm making you you don't go as big as a gathering stitch.
No, about three.
Oh, okay.
Three and a half on your on your machine. I'm going to put my weird gloves on now.
Yeah, now I saw you getting those out. And why do you wear
it's
gloves?
It's a personal thing, but quilting gloves, when you're trying to move a lot of fabric through the machine, and admittedly the foot's taking it through, it's not as bad as free motion quilting, but I just find my hands, when you're dealing with a lot of fabric, they go very slippery, and it is quite weighty actually, although it doesn't feel like it, to be pushing through a machine.
Well, if you're doing this is a baby quilt, but if you're doing like a quilt on a king size bed or whatever, it's going to be a lot, isn't it? Can I just feel them?
Yes.
Because they look like they've got
They're quite normal fabric on the top in areas, and then they've got some sort of a little bit of a grip almost.
Yes, like an animal that climbs up the side of walls and things like that. Do you know what I mean? Like almost, not suction caps, but like kind of that kind of feel.
Yeah, Spider-Man gloves on.
We sell those. If you go to the website, small, medium, large, they come in. I'll try and find the details for you, but they are available on... are you a small, a medium or a large?
Small.
So you buy them for the size you are, really?
That's it.
Yeah. Like rubber gloves?
Yes.
OK, now I'm going to let you get on. I'll be quiet while you do this.
Well, I'm just going to... the ones that I've gone straight across, I've done no securing stitches whatsoever before I begin.
Right.
But because I'm starting here to come out, I am just going to do a few stitches, just securing stitches on the spot... here, before I go, where's my foot pedal? Now, if you don't have a securing stitch button on your machine, what you can just do is just drop the stitch length down.
Yeah.
And put a couple of stitches in.
Oh, I can see. Right, can we see that? Because jumping up and down.
Yeah, you can see the feed dogs actually better now because they're now the foot's down. And what you have to do when you fit the walking foot, this bar here goes above the needle plate. I don't know if you can see
that. Okay, you need to point from this side.
Okay. You see that?
There you go.
Always fit that above the needle bar there, so when the needle's going up and down, that is what's operating the feed dog.
Oh, yes.
You see? It's very clever.
I thought they were doing it by magic, then.
I know.
remember, you can get in touch with the show. Lisa's just texted in saying she's watching the show. She's watching from home. This programme is absolutely great. I'm surprised she's up. It's Saturday morning, 9:20. She'd normally be just coming home from the night before, or Lisa would be, yes.
So we're just bumping along there. Now, like you were saying with a bigger quilt, often you see a lot of photographs showing machines where a quilt rolled here in the body of the machine.
Yes.
And actually, I was always advised to scrunch a machine rather than roll it. If you roll a piece of fabric,
yes,
it gets quite stiff, doesn't it? A bit like when you roll a newspaper.
Yes, 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 yes.
So I always, my advice would be to just gather it. So I could turn this around, but
yes,
now
yes,
if I wanted to do this, you see, I'm just gathering it in the body of the machine.
But would you do that when you have a big, full-bodied, yep, quilt? You still scrunch it all,
yep,
in there? Yeah,
because if you roll that, it's just a very awkward...
Oh, yeah, well, also, not only is it heavier, but it's also making it more rigid.
More
like
rigid.
A, you know, like putting a pole through there almost, wouldn't
Absolutely,
it?
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay. So now you're not physically pushing that through because the
feed dogs are taking it, so you're just sort of smoothing everything out. And basically with quilting, just basically concentrate on the bits that you can see,
yeah,
between your hands, and just keep feeding it through. Like you say, then you can reposition the quilt as you go if you're working on something larger.
And just take your time doing
it. Just take
it, really,
your time,
as well.
Yeah. Doesn't really, no hurry. So I'm just now going to do the other two. I've got two
Where's
more
your
here.
Thread?
My thread.
I didn't see you cut your thread then.
Oh, I used... This machine's got a fancy scissor button. So...
I'm very old school, and I always have my threads really, really long. I'm pulling out the back because I'm always terrified they're going to either shoot back into the bobbin or
yes,
shoot back up into the needle.
There we go. I know I always hang on to mine at the back of the machine.
So the one, the lines that you start mid-quilt, you're doing a backstitch on, but the ones when you run into the hem, where the binding's going to go, you just run it off,
yes,
into
Yes, I've
there.
Just ran those off.
Yeah.
These ones, obviously, where we're in the centre of the quilt,
yes,
we need something to secure and tie in.
Now, if you were a little bit nervous and just starting off, would you draw the line in?
No.
Did you never draw the line in when you first started?
No, not really.
She's never nervous, Angela.
No, I am.
That's the problem. You're not.
I am.
She was quiet.
We all get nervous, don't we?
We had a meeting, right? Oh, I love that. On the meeting on the first day, right, where all the experts met each other, all the designers met each other, and everyone was very quiet and demure. And
was I quiet?
You were very quiet on that day.
Normally people wouldn't say that about
me. No, you were very quiet that day. Next day she was in. No, not quiet.
Bit different.
Not quiet at all.
No, I'm not known for being quiet.
Oh, Teabag Barbara's watching. Oh, Teabag Barbara. She's not very good at sewing, but she's loving the show. Teabag Barbara is that's my nickname for her, lovely Barbara, because she sends me presents of teabags, lovely teabags. In fact, I think there's a parcel waiting for us. Sort of recognise the writing out in the main room for me there. So if that's for you, Teabag Barbara, thank you. And if it's not, why isn't it? Anyway.
There we go.
You'd have to be called... I have to get you a new nickname now. You have to learn how to sew. Because you know Shamoya Mary as well. She always watches too. And she's got a whole craft room. Can't sew. We did Mitered Corners the other day and she was like, I was lost. She was lost. So we're going to have to watch these, Shamoya Mary. You'll love it. Got lots of different skills, right?
Okay, so we can quilt as much, as I said, as much or as little as we like.
Yeah.
What you'll find is, I don't know if I'm in the right place there. Yeah. So take these gloves off now. Your ends, as I was saying, in the middle.
Yes.
When you've got ends in the middle of a quilt, you'd want to tidy those.
Yes.
So what I've done here is I've pulled the top thread through to the back.
I was just waiting. I didn't want you to do it without the viewers at home being able to see it. And Timothy's a bit slow today on the overhead camera. It's just that perching on the beams up there. Right.
Okay. So what I've done here is I've just put a little knot. You can knot right down near the fabric,
yeah,
if you like, but a little knot just further away as well. What I find...
Hang on a sec. So it's not... You haven't knotted down there.
You can knot there as well. But there's a little knot there, which is, I'm going to feed it into the, this is what I find, you know, I was talking to you the other day about self-threading needles.
Yes.
And I always wondered what the point was until I found what the point was.
Okay.
So now, with these two ends, you'd be forever, wouldn't you, trying
yes,
to get both of those through the end of a needle. So, the self-threading needle's got this sort of second open eye in the top.
Right.
So I've just been able to push those on there,
right,
which is great. And then what we can do is we can just go back down the final hole. Now I'm actually between the sandwich now,
right,
so just under the top layer of, you can see the needle there, just
yeah,
under the top layer of the fabric, and just go along a little way. Make sure that you're not coming through, especially with a nice navy thread.
Yeah.
Then I'm going to come out and you'll actually hear a little pop as that knot
go on then
Did you hear a little pop?
No.
The cameras aren't sensitive enough, but you can feel it.
The microphone, not a camera.
You can, sorry, yes. You can feel the little knot pull into the wadding, and obviously it's just going to give it that little bit of security that it won't come back out.
Oh, wow.
And then you can just nip that off.
And then the end will just hide underneath it.
Yeah.
In the...
I didn't nick
How
that
brilliant
quite.
Is that? A lot of you asking about there this elephant on blue. It's gorgeous, isn't it? This is the elephant
lovely,
here. £5.45 for half a metre. We do sell our fabrics in half metre increments. And do you know what? When you buy the fabric, it's just the fabric, it comes in the most gorgeous box, wrapped in tissue paper. When you buy fabric by the metre, that's such a... Anyway.
Okay, so a bit tedious, but that's what you do with all your ends if you have them in the centre. And then when you've quilted as much as you like, then we need to trim.
Okay, so before you trim, how much backing fabric do you need to buy? Because you need to back it and you need to pipe it. So if you need to back this, so you'll need...
Because this panel's 60 centimetres wide, obviously you're not going to get that out of half a metre.
No.
So obviously if you buy a metre, then you'll have enough left over to do your binding as well.
So that'll be two units for a metre, if you're buying on the web. If you're buying on the ring in the call centre, they'll be able to help you.
And actually, as I was making this, I realised if I'd have been a little cleverer...
Oh, yes.
Because I just went
along... Is that possible?
If I just went along with... Obviously, you put everything the same way. But then I thought, because I could imagine this then in a cot, and you'd fold the top over... And my elephants will be upside down.
Yeah.
So you could put the back on upside down.
Oh,
so when
no,
you
could have been
it
clever.
That could
then.
Have been clever.
But could you also, if you've had a bit of spillage of the, I don't know what babies eat, baby food, right?
Stuffing jar.
Could you then turn it over and use that side? Because it's just it's a quilt that way as well, isn't
still
it?
Fine.
So you could just use it. It's a
just
reversible one, isn't
just
it?
Just as nice, yeah.
Oh, I don't know. I'm really showing myself up, aren't I? Right, okay, so what's the next stage then?
Okay, so I'm need to trim now, so now I need my mat.
What do you need
to
do
that? Huge mat.
Yes.
And my long, trusty
your long ruler.
Yeah.
You got it, that's a huge mat, isn't it?
It is a huge mat.
Fantastic mat.
See?
Which rotary blades would you like, Matt?
The middle one, please.
The middle 45mm, there you go.
Thank you.
Okay, I'll just move that to one side.
So now, because it's a panel as well, and things move a lot when they're when they're quilted, that's why you have a little bit of overlap at the edges.
Right.
So because things shift, you can see we've got a bit of a wavy line, and things move. So we just need to straighten it up as much as possible. So we can use the rule to look at either a row of stitching or where these blocks, it's looking fairly parallel.
Yes,
so we'll try and line it up with something like that, and you can see there where the edge is waving in and out, so we just try and keep it as parallel as possible.
So
there's as little as possible.
Oh, sorry.
You see, I'm not losing anything here, but I'm going to be chopping there.
Are you cutting it to the size that you want it? You're not having to add seam allowances.
I'm not worrying about what the finished size is or anything like that. So, and then we're going to, with the long ruler, as you travel along, it can easily slip.
Right.
And so. My advice is to spread your hand as wide as possible. I always stick my little finger off the edge of the rule just to stop it slipping.
You want to have your little... I've got to get a box for you to stand on.
I need to start working in heels.
Well, I was going to say, you've got lovely little trainers on down there. If you wore your going-out shoes, you'd be all right, wouldn't you?
No, I need to borrow some heels.
Oh, you're not a heels girl?
I'm not a heels girl, no.
I thought you'd be all...
Did you? No.
All right, okay, we're just watching you there, slicing away.
As I get so far, I'm going to travel my hand.
Oh.
You see? And travel a bit further so that the rule doesn't slip. And we go as far as possible. Make sure.
Okay, as you can see, we're using the ruler from the first show, the 61 by 16 centimetre ruler there, £15.95. A much, much bigger cutting mat than we had in the first show there. That's £39.95. Next, we'll talk about this in a minute. Self-healing. It's a self-healing mat.
Then I need to...
Do you need me to lift you up? Oh, you say lift me up then?
Yeah.
It could be a piggyback, John.
I need to move the quilt down. And then again, we just realign again as best we can. I'm going to go there. And travel along. Okay. So then we'd just be continuing...
Oh, sorry, I was just trying to talk to Hannah then and they're all ignoring me upstairs.
We're going to continue that all the way down and trim it nice and precisely ready for our wadding.
Okay, now notice you've kept the... Because a lot of people would have cut that off, the kind of almost selvage pattern.
I cut a little bit of the actual selvage, the spot, the dots. But I actually quite like the elephants. So, yeah, I kept those in.
Right, can I leave you? No, cut that one, cut that one, cut that one. Then when you do the other two, somebody's asked to see one of the fabrics again. So what I'll do is I'll just let you cut that one so we can see your technique.
Then I can carry on cutting.
Yes.
Always put the blade away safely when you finish cutting, and always cut away from yourself.
And always remember to
lock it back off.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's kind of you get into the habit of doing it if you do it right from the start.
Exactly. All right, I'll let you cut the other two, because whilst you're asking about these fabulous fabrics, I thought I was going to trip over them. But
don't do that.
So, we'll start off with the panels, because you're loving, loving, loving the panels. This is the one that Angie's using. It's called a jungle print. Now, it doesn't. We don't sell this by the half metre. You buy this by the panel, right? So the panel is 60 centimetres by 112, did we say it was? 112 centimetres. You get the whole panel. Now, if you want two panels, you can buy two panels, or three or four. They will all arrive joined up, as in they won't cut them off. So if you ordered four panels, for example, they would come all joined up and not cut individually. Beautiful, isn't it? £6.95. Now, you know that the Makoa fabrics are just out of this world. The cotton is just beautiful. Well, next to a baby, you want lovely cotton. I would also suggest washing it before you do your first, because you're going to just get rid of any dressing or dust or anything that might have landed on the fabric while it's been in the warehouse, whatever. But beautiful, isn't it? So that is the Makoa Baby Jungle Panel. And that's how it comes, 60 centimetres by 112 centimetres. That is gorgeous. Now, I'll show you the other panel, which you haven't seen being used at the moment. That's this one. Now, this is... Hannah loves this one. She adores this one. But do you know what? This is the panel, right? So that's the panel. Again, it doesn't come in the half metre. It comes in the panel, right? So you get that really, really lovely blocks fabric panel. Gorgeous, £5.45. Remember, it's a 60 centimetre by 112 centimetres. £5.45. That is lovely. All those, like, they're little stamps, aren't they? Now, imagine if you were a quilter and you just wanted... You didn't really want to just use the fabric. You wanted to quilt with that. You could so easily just chop those all up. £5.45 for that panel. Hang on. I don't even know what that is, Hannah. Hannah's saying, when she was little, her mum made had stickers, a reward chart, and you put presents in them. I've got no idea what she's talking about. But anyway, I wouldn't use that. Yes. So where should we go now? Blue. Oh, this is lovely. Now you see this fab. Now we're onto fabrics now. So we sell this by the half metre increment. So you can buy half metre and then increments up from there to a metre, metre and a half, 2 metres. If you buy on the web, so half a metre would be one increment. So if you wanted a metre, you'd buy two units. This is beautiful. I mean, you don't even need to use this for a child's one. This could be a grown up fabric as well, couldn't it? It's really, really cute. £5.45 for 50 centimetres. Now this, when you buy this will come in a box wrapped in tissue paper. When you buy fabrics, they come in the box wrapped in tissue paper. Beautiful. £5.45. Now remember, it doesn't matter how many units of anything you buy, right? You pay £2.95 for P&P. Now, you could use that to back the quilt. Now, how much did we say? A metre. So you'd need two units of that if you want to back the quilt with that. But you know what? That looks lovely as cushions. In your conservatory or in your dining room. That would look lovely in your dining room. Then we'll move on to... Now, this, going back to the children's themes again. We love this. We love this. Now, maybe for older children, maybe, because very educational. Hannah just said, I'm going to stop talking about children. Then she went on about primary school. Look at this. You've got every letter of the alphabet in here. I mean, you could teach them the letters, couldn't you, with this? I mean, they wouldn't be in order, obviously. Look. £5.45 for half a metre. It's the alphabet on blue background. Now, it goes lovely with the elephants as well. That and the elephants together would look fabulous, wouldn't it? I really love that. What were you just saying? You'd make something else that's better, would you?
Oh, I love that one.
We love it.
Why didn't you send me that one?
Oh, now. Somebody's texted in saying, "What make a fabulous book bag for kiddies to take their books to school." But you're coming back to make a book
cover later. So the book cover we're making is like a very adult, sophisticated one. When I was at school, you covered your books in old wallpaper, didn't you, and brown paper and things, whereas you can make a gorgeous book cover if they've got their first diary, as they get older, you know what I mean? Fantastic, that's beautiful. This is the other one in that range. This is also a very grown-up fabric, and versatile. I'll turn it around that way. Versatile fabric, because you've got all the gorgeous colours, all the beautiful, beautiful colours that you get in all the Macawa fabrics, but they're in that kind of almost hand-drawn chalk stripe. Isn't it lovely? That's really beautiful. Now, lovely, gorgeous close-up there, Ginger Mike. Thank you very much indeed for seeing all the colours and all the stripes there. Again, £5.45 for half a metre. And then last but not least in this range, we've got the elephants, which we love this, and you're loving this as well. This is the one that Angie's used to back her Cot Quilt. Look, aren't they? Again, you see, I'd have this in my house. It wouldn't necessarily have to be in a children's room, would it? I'd have that. Oh, where would I have that? I'd make Norman and Nellie a cat bed out of it. Or I'd have it, I've got this big wooden Indian, turn-of-the-century Indian sofa in my dining room. Could have there. Or upstairs, I've got my kind of Indian bed that I bought, turn-of-the-century bed, upstairs. You could make a throw for the bed with that. I think it'd be beautiful. Oh, thank you, that's my Christmas. Oh, my birthday first, Hannah. Do it for my birthday, not Christmas. And then right now, also complementing these colours, I'll just take you through these, are these four linear. They're the four linear fabrics. Now, I need to point out, they're calling this one duck egg, but I would definitely say pale grey. Pale grey, I'd say. Schoolboy grey, I'd say that one was. Linear texture fabric, they're calling it duck egg, but it's definitely a grey. That's the £4.95 half metre. Then here, you see here, the mustard. This is the one they saw. Now Hannah's loving this, right? But she's got lots of things in her house this colour. Have you got lots of, like, 1950s things? Because I think this and the orange look very, very 1950s. Really, really lovely 50 prints. Anyway, that's the mustard. And then if we move down, we've got two other colours here. We've got the orange next to me, and we've got the teal there. Really gorgeous, aren't they? They do look fabulous together, don't they? So this one here is the orange. Oh, and that's the teal there. So we'll put the teal in first. Again, look at that gorgeous print on there. Now, the fabric is a cotton, right? It's a cotton. It's not... It's called a textured fabric, but it's actually only the print. It's a print on the top. It's not actually a linen or a textured fabric. It's just a textured print. So that is the teal. And then this is the orange here next to me. That's the orange. That's the teal. That's the orange there. Both graphics on screen. But if you're confused, just ring the call centre, 0800 112 4433. Right, I'm coming back. Because we need to finish this quilt, don't we?
Yes. So I'm going to be talking about adding the binding now, okay, that we've got it all...
So if you've just tuned in, you've trimmed that down, yes, while I was chatting. Oh, we've got loads of time to this. So, yes.
I need Wonder Clips.
A Wonder Clips?
Yes.
Where are they?
I don't know, actually.
Oh, Amy, where are the Wonder Clips on this show? Okay, she'll Jane will just get them for us now. So you've made this binding.
Yes, so to work out what length of binding you need to add, if you add up all four sides of your quilt that you're making, and then I always add 10 inches to that, so to get your length. Now, this has been cut just from the bolt of your fabric, you normally get about 42 inches from a strip.
Yes.
So you can work out, divide it by 42, you work out how many strips to cut. They're 2.5 inches wide. See that? So cut strips of 2.5 inches.
You're not going to need me soon. Look, at the first show, I was like, I'll just put this here. Just put this here. It's done it all for us. Now, it's on the straight, isn't it? It's not on the bias.
Yes, we're doing, because we're not doing any curves.
Yes.
So it's just straight cut, straight binding. 2.5 inch wide strips, and then I've just pressed it in half. And then what I've done before you press them, actually, is just keep joining them.
Just with a straight seam.
Just with a straight seam and press the seams open. So here's my
finished
bundle
one,
ready to go on this quilt. I'll show you the first. There's a seam there.
So it's a straightforward. Because it's a straight fabric, straight seam.
Quarter of an inch seam, pressed open. Yeah, and then I've just wound all that so it's easy to use. And I've just folded an end in.
You've just folded what in?
An end over, ready to start. what we're going to do is to remember how to attach it.
Oh, hang on, just looking at the end, sorry, yeah. There. Just looking at the end.
Ready to go, we're there, yeah. There we go, got that. So then we're going to always remember to go raw edge to raw edge.
Okay, so you're not now doing it like a bias binding where you...
Where it's pre-folded.
Yes.
It is going to wrap around.
Yes.
But this is a really simple way so that we're not worried about capturing the bottom.
Oh, okay.
Okay, and it's all the seams are hidden. You won't see any stitching
this way.
So this raw edge to raw edge, and this is where I like to use the Wonder Clips rather than pins.
Okay. Why would you use Wonder Clips rather than pins?
Well, you know, pins through all that are, you know, quite mm-hmm. difficult, and these are just so quick and easy, really. And it's just to keep them, just to keep everything in place.
When I was training, we didn't have Wonder Clips.
I know. Well, you don't need a lot, really, before we go to the machine. So you just need a couple just to help you along. And I'm just going to move this now into a quarter inch seam. So I'm mm-hmm. just moving my needle over and just lengthen my
stitch. So now you've still got... Are you able to still use your...
Keep the walking foot on. Yeah, because you can actually do decorative stitches with the walking
foot. Oh, okay, so it's not... So it's quite versatile. Yep. You can use it for other things
Absolutely.
As well.
Absolutely. So you've got a full swing of the width of your machine. So I've just moved the needle across and I'll just use the edge of the foot to sort of allocate my quarter of an inch seam.
Seam allowance,
there.
Yeah.
And as I was saying about folding that in, you'd think that that's the wrong way, but of course when this is folded over,
of course,
that's going to be hidden.
Yeah.
So it's all a bit backwards. And then I'm just going to, if I do one mitered corner for you to see.
Just get this quick look at the stitching. Now. So you're quarter of an inch from the
Put the needle
edge.
Down. Yes, quarter of an inch from the edge. And normally I would scoot that out of the way.
Oh. Normally you would.
Normally I would. What was I going to say? Oh, change my top colour, my top thread.
Oh, okay.
So I've got cream in the top at the moment, but generally I would change over then to match
the navy,
the blue.
To match the blue.
But you may not see it, and maybe it's easier to see on camera.
No, because you just said you weren't going to see any stitches, so we won't see it.
But if you were to put it under pressure, you might see a little bit. So we can just go along to a corner. And we can just move the Wonder Clip down as I'm working.
Yeah.
We can just go... Stitch along until you're about a quarter of an inch from the edge of the corner.
Yeah.
And I'm just going to stop there. And then I'm actually going to take it out of the machine. We've got a thread cutter there.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we've stitched along there.
So how far have you gone down? Right to the end? Or have
about
you left
a quarter
of an inch to seam allowance,
from the
yes.
edge. So that we can see this mm-hmm. now. Right. And then this is the trick. So we fold this back.
Hang on one sec. Let's just let the camera catch up.
Yeah. Fold this back at a 45-degree angle.
Yeah.
The way to remember is fold it away from yourself is what I always remember. And then I fold this back again. So we've got this nice, very neat crossover. We can just pin that in place again
clip
clip it with a Wonder Clip, and we go back to the machine, and then I can just carry on.
So you've still got raw edge to raw edge along here.
Still raw edge to raw edge there.
But that's got a fold
that's
in the
fold
fabric there.
With the 45 degrees underneath.
Okay, perfect.
Okay, so I'm gonna do this now. See, there's lots to hold in place as you come back.
Okay, we've just had a message in. Yes. The backing fabric. If you want, well, somebody just asked how much backing fabric they need to buy. It depends which fabric you use, because this way, the Andrew's used the elephants, but I think you'd be, I'll just watch you stitching that while I worked out, because you'd actually need the length of it, which would be 112 centimetres, wouldn't you, if you're going to do your elephants this way round, because they go across the fabric.
You can just about fit the panel on the width. It's very, very tight.
Oh, okay.
But then your elephants
would go the other way, sideways.
Yeah.
So if you wanted your elephants to be going, so on the on the stripy one, it wouldn't matter. On the alphabet-y one, it wouldn't matter. But if you've got stripes going across like this, you'd need 112 plus a little bit, so you need a metre and a half.
Yeah.
If you're having your elephants, so if you have this one with the elephants going across, you need a metre and a half, which would be 3 units. But if you've got one of the other fabrics, you could cut it out across ways like that, which means you just need 1 metre.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's okay.
So I've just, it doesn't really matter where you start, just start from the end again as we go. Just going to go along there a little.
Okay,
and obviously then. I'd continue until the next corner. But if I take this out, because what I'm going to do, I've got a smaller version.
Yes, Hannah, we'll just explain that. Thank you.
End.
Patricia's emailed in. Hello, Patricia, my love. Good morning to you.
Oh. Does she have a question?
Wait for this, Angie. Patricia watches every day, right? She'll get another day watching my favourite new channel. This is the best quilting demonstration I've seen ever.
Oh, that's nice. Thank
that's
you,
Patricia.
Patricia.
Okay, so right. Okay, so we'll just stop here.
Yeah.
Because you've stitched.
So I just started again on that seam, and I've just stitched down. I've stitched down to the next corner.
Okay.
But this is now going. I'm going to show you the reveal of the mitered corner.
Okay.
So then this would just push over.
Bit like me, I'm a pushover, that's what people say.
Got my frayed edges coming through there.
Yeah, you can just chop those away.
So you can see that already coming. Naturally, a mitered corner, beautiful mitered corner, just appears. And then when you turn it over, you've got a nice folded edge. It's not a raw edge.
Yes.
And very easy when you come to, I don't know if you can see this. You would
that's
then,
in the way, though.
Beautiful folded edge. Then you can slip stitch this down, and very easy when you come to the corners then to just again fold that in, and you end up with your mitered corner.
Perfect.
Sitting beautifully. So I like to finish them this way because there's absolutely no stitching on show, and actually the slip stitch is very strong.
But if you wanted to machine it, if you're better at machining than you are hand stitching, rather than slip stitching down there, could you machine through that?
You could do your binding double folded to begin with and put it on and machine it down. I always find if you slip off that way,
yeah, with bias binding, sometimes you slip off like old fashioned bias. But if you were to stitch it like you have, like that, fold it over, fold it over, and you didn't want to do the hand stitching down there, you could just machine down in the ditch, down in the ditch of the stitching there.
That's right, yeah. And just to show you, when you finally get to the end, I've got a small one so that you didn't have to...
Have we got time to see another corner? As if by magic.
Oh.
if by magic. Can you just explain, because I just want to see the corner again, because if you missed it the first time, this is like perfect, a really, really good example of it now.
I've done a little baby quilt here because I thought it'd be quite boring for the viewers to see me stitching around that whole quilt. So this is a little miniature version. So you can see all my mitered corners there, ready to fold back. But when you get back round to where you started, just a little tip, you can see my end there folded in, my raw edge folded in, so that when that tucks over, it'll be tucked in. Under the machine, can I go under the machine
just
to finish this off? Got white thread in there so you can see what I'm doing. Quarter of an inch from the end again. So I'm just going to come along until I've crossed over. You can just see where you've started.
Yeah.
And then just a little tip, leaving the needle in, to just angle this away. I don't know if you can see that.
We can watch you perfectly.
Pull this angle away. Try and keep the machine going in a straight line.
But you've angled your
fabric. You've angled the fabric. It's a little bit tricky. We can go like that. Go along.
Oh, so you go right the way over it all?
Yep. So we can go, we can pull it. Oh, I've probably gone too far there. There we go. What this does, if you angle it away, we can chop that away.
Yes.
But as you fold, if I'd left that carrying on straight, as you fold it over, you end up with the underneath layer protruding over this layer.
Yes.
But by angling it underneath,
right.
It actually sits, you see, shorter.
Yes.
So that then when you come to slip stitch this side, otherwise it sticks out further.
Oh.
And then you just chop your end off. obviously gone too far down there now, haven't I?
I like the way to do the mini quilt. Corner. You've used one of the squares off off the panel there.
A little bit free machine quilting over those little.
Oh, we'll be doing more free machine quilting. But you know what? If you didn't use the whole panel for the baby cot quilt, you could make like sort of not coasters for a chap, you know, but the things put down so you're not marking your furniture with like the milk bottle or the food bottle or anything like that. You could use that as a kind of protector on the top and everything.
Yeah, you can use that. They're great fun, aren't they? They're super fabrics.
Now, before we go any further, we've had lots and lots of people asking about your gloves.
Oh, okay.
These. So we're just going to say, we do sell these. If you go to the website, just explain how they work again.
Well, because I think I got into wearing gloves because I do a lot of free machining.
Yes.
And free machine quilting. So you haven't got the feed dogs moving the fabric, but also your hands get really soft, you know, when you want to lick them to.
Yes. Well, no.
And you don't really want to be doing that. Yes. If you're making things for people, you don't really want to be licking thread and fabric.
No.
It's not really good. So, these gloves are quilting gloves, and they're a little bit like a gardening glove, but they're a bit more breathable, I think.
Yes, because that was good. One lady's email didn't she put her name in it, so it might be a gentleman, but do your hands not get sweaty inside the gloves?
Because they're kind of built for quilters, made for quilters, and so they can be a little bit more breathable than a gardening glove.
Yes.
As I said, it is personal preference. I do know people that don't wear them, but
if you're doing lots and lots of it, also they're going to almost protect your hand, aren't they?
Because you do get very dry handling fabric all the time, so I like to wear them. And actually, it's quite, I feel quite lost without them on, actually.
Oh, because but to start with, I bet you feel a bit odd putting a pair of gloves on to do stitching. But if you go to the website, you can get these. We've got the graphics for the small. Oh, for the small. That's the graphic for the small there. Oh, that's £3.95. Now, you use yours every day when you're doing quilting, don't you?
Yeah, and they get terribly dirty, actually.
Can you wash them?
Yes,
they're washable,
wash them.
I'm sure.
Yeah, they're totally washable. But you'd be amazed how much dirt.
Yes, exactly. So for £3.95, you get the small ones here. If you want the medium or the large, you need to go to the website to check on those and put one in your basket. I just need to also point out, because we were talking about different coloured threads earlier, these are quilting 100% cotton threads. And what I love about these is look at all the colours. Look at all the fabulous colours in there. So now, what's the difference between quilting thread, would you say, than a normal stitching thread?
It depends what, because we talked about patchwork and quilting being two different things, really.
Yes.
For patchwork, we tend to use a very fine thread because we don't want to add to that bulk with piecing. With a quilting thread, quilters tend to use cotton because they're using cotton fabric, so there'll be no polyester mix in there at all, just so that over years and years of that quilt being washed and used, that the fabrics are going to wear at the same rate.
Yes.
So these are 100% cotton,
yes,
aren't they?
Yes, they are.
And for quilting. So for the top finish of your quilt rather than piecing. But they're lovely, aren't they? A lovely range.
They're gorgeous, aren't they? So you get 10 spools for £17.95. That's fantastic. Isn't that? And I love those colours, because you're more likely to use in patchwork or in quilting, you're more likely to use some of those gorgeous colours, aren't they?
They are a 50 weight.
Right.
If ladies wanted to know what weight they are, the experts out there, well, they'll be interested
Thank
in the
you.
Weight of the thread.
At £17.95 then. We're on quilting day. We're bringing you all sorts of things quilting. So,
am I going to finish that while you...
Oh, yes. What would you like to finish?
I can just carry on with my corner, shall I?
You're saying you want to go now?
No.
So what we've
Unless
done... Now also the clips, Angie. A lot of you asking about the clips. If you're watching, in which show are we doing these in? Is it 11 o'clock show? We'll have the details of those in the 11 o'clock. We're going to put you the details, or of course you can just ring the call centre, pop them in your basket. Okay, so while you do that,
I'll carry on.
Am I going back over there to do fabrics?
Are you?
Oh, hang on, what are you coming up? Because I won't be back. What are you doing? Oh, I know what you're doing. It's 11.
We're doing a patchwork book cover this Saturday. We did a free motion quilted one last Saturday, but we've got a patchwork cover.
With exclusive fabric.
Fabrics, yes.
Okay, well, you stay there then. Thanks, Angie.
I'll see you later.
You will do. Right, okay. The panels, the gorgeous panel that we've been using for the whole of this, it's limited. It is now limited stock, I'm being told. This is gorgeous, isn't it? The panel itself. Now, you don't buy this by the half metre. You buy this by the panel, right? The panel is 60 centimetres by 112 centimetres. One Angie used. So if you want it wider, you need to buy two panels. You don't buy it by the half metre on this one. £6.95 for that really, really gorgeous panel there. 100% cotton, fabulous quality Makoa cotton as well, at £6.95. Pence. Okay, now that's that panel. Now the other panel is stunning as well, isn't it? It's really, really cute, this one. This is fabulous. Look at this. I know, isn't it a lovely panel? Look at all the different animals on there. Look at all the really, really lovely little animals on there. They've all got their own little characters there. The Blocks fabric panel by Makoa, 60 centimetres. £5.45 for the pan, for the panel, that one is, remember, £5.45. That is lovely, isn't it? Okay, so then we also had the complementary fabric. We had the blue fabric with triangles, which we love. Now, this is very, very, very versatile. You could use this for grown-ups as well as children, couldn't you? I love this. I really, really love this print. It's that beautiful blue. So remember, so half-metre increments this sells in at £5.45 for half a metre. Triangles on blue background at £5.45. Isn't that lovely? Now, you can ring the call centre, 0800 112 4433, or, of course, you can go on the web, www.sewingquarter.com. If you need to buy this while we're on air, you need to go to the page where you're watching us. I'll just do a little dance. Alphabet next. We love this. You can make it into a school bag. You can make it into a book cover, anything. It's really, really... pencil case. Make it into a pencil case as well. Hannah's full of creative ideas this morning. Alphabet on blue background, at half a metre, £5.45. Just give the call centre a ring and say the alphabet you want. They'll know exactly what you mean. OK, very quickly, I'll just show you the elephant one, which we've been showing you all show. The other ones... Now, if you go to the web, all the other ones are listed there. Isn't this beautiful? Really lovely. That's the one we've been using with the elephants going across there. £5.45 for half a metre. This one is very, very popular, almost as popular as the panel. £5.45 for half a metre. All the other fabrics you can go and look at on the web, remember. If you go to today's webpage, Watch Us Live, you can go down. There's a shopping list of everything that we've shown for the last 2 hours. Now, don't go anywhere. We've got a short 3-minute break now, and I'm going to have my quick bite of a strawberry. We've got Jo's back, and she's making... we've got mini irons. Now, this is a fantastic thing. If you've never seen a mini iron, make sure you tune in 3 minutes' time. It's the most fascinating thing. I'd never even seen one before. Go nowhere. 3 minutes, mini irons.
The Sewing Quarter is a new, inspirational sewing and quilting channel here to help educate our viewers with some of the best designers in the business. We hope to bring you some exciting demonstrations with some of the top industry experts. We're part of the Immediate Media family. Immediate Media is a fast-growing multi-platform company who operates some of the most loved brands across the UK. Our brands range from our first TV shopping channel adventure with Jewellery Maker to several successful magazines such as Simply Sewing, Radio Times, BBC Good Food and many more. We've been working incredibly hard to set up and bring you our new exciting channel, and we hope that we can help inspire you with new ideas and projects.
Here at the Sewing Quarter, you'll hear us talking about pre-cuts a lot of the time. And I can hear you saying, what's a pre-cut, John? Now, pre-cuts, they're pieces of fabric that have been bundled together, all cut to the same size, usually from complementary fabrics, so you've got a lovely little bundle to take home and start your sewing. Pre-cuts come in all shapes and sizes, but here are a few of the most popular. This is a jelly roll. I love jelly rolls. Now, these are normally 40 strips of fabric. They are all 110 by 6.35 centimetres. To you and me, that's 44 inches by 2.5 inches wide. They're normally cut from 8 different fabrics, but look how gorgeous they are. Now, one word of warning. They look beautiful like this. When you cut them open, all the fabric spreads everywhere. You'll never, ever be able to put them back together again. This is a charm pack. There are 42 pieces of fabric, 12.7 centimetres by 12.7 centimetres. So basically, it's a 5-inch square. You get so many gorgeous fabrics in a charm pack, you'll find an awful lot of patterns inside a charm pack as well. Another favourite pack is the Fat Quarter Pack. Now, these measure 55 centimetres by 50 centimetres, or like me, 22 inches by 20 inches. Now, you normally find lots of different fabrics all bundled together. They're all different colours, all different shapes, but you know what? Unlike the jelly rolls and unlike the charm packs, the number of pieces of fabric can alter from 2 to 30. Look! Whichever pre-cut you choose, you've just got to remember two things. One, all the fabrics will go so beautifully together. And two, someone else has done the boring, laborious task of cutting them all out. So it's all about getting on with the sewing, which is what we love here at the Sewing Quarter. When you spend £10 on your first purchase, you will receive this free sewing kit from the Sewing Quarter worth £14.99. Hello, welcome back, welcome back. I'm starting over this side. Did you have a lovely break?
I did.
In the end of that, Joe's last hour, her tummy, I don't know if you heard it at home, your tummy was... And I thought it was a car outside. I think, oh, those cars outside are noisy. And then at the end of the show, she said, do you hear my tummy rumbling? So you've had some breakfast now, I hope.
I have.
So, it's at Quilting Day. It's Quilting Day. What are... Oh, this is... I just think this is fascinating. I've never seen one of these before. We're going to be showing that mini iron, apart from everything else in this hour, aren't we? But what... Are we making something? Are we going to make something?
We're making a couple of little projects.
Yes.
So, some little coasters and a sunglasses pouch.
Oh, yes. I saw you come in with that this morning, yeah. Mm-hmm. Perfect. So let's have a look. Let me have a look. Actually, let's get the piece, the sunglasses and the coaster. And then I just need the sunglasses and the coaster, Amy, please. And then we can show that as well. Oh, thank you. Right, so. Oh, these are cute. So are these all patchwork and quilted?
Yes. And the binding is made...
Sorry, I'm just going to press you.
The backing fabric, so it's backing and binding in one. So there's some little pressing that needs to be done around the sides and perfect for the mini iron.
Now, there's a reason you made this, isn't there?
There is. One of my favourite handbags, I can't get my purse in and my sunglasses in the hard case. So they don't get scratched, I made a soft...
But they have to be sunglasses, because I find that with my glasses... I carry so many pairs of glasses around with me. They'd be perfect just for throwing my glasses in my bag, wouldn't they, as well? Perfect. So, which one are we going to start with?
We'll start with the coasters.
Perfect. OK. I think these are so cute. Oh, so they're plain on one side with the backing, and then... So you've used one of the fat quarters for this?
Yes.
Oh, we've not seen this one before. This is nice. I'll just go to that thread there. This is lovely. Look at this. This is just called... Oh! It's got to call plain. There's nothing plain about that. They're gorgeous. Those fabulous, fabulous colours, aren't they? Really, really lovely colours there. Oh, there's a still of it as well. Have I got this one sewn together, Amy? Have I got one of these sewn together? Oh, because I've not seen this one before. I think it's lovely. Look at the colours in there. I'll go through them all in a second for you. You've got that lovely mulberry, you've got the red, there you've got the greens, and then you've got that lovely... We'll go through them in a second. So, you started off with a fat quarter for £8.95.
I did. And I'm going to make one of the checkerboard with two colours for the patchwork now.
Not the three... how many colours has that one got in it?
That's
one's got four colours, yeah. No, so, I quite like that. Did you make six of these by any chance?
No.
Oh.
I need to keep going too.
After the show, all the pieces that our experts have made are all sitting, tempting us on this display as you come in through the door. And the little cat doorstop that I'm having and the daft excluder I'm having are all there. And I haven't dared leave yet to them. But I need six coasters, not
six.
Just
okay.
The one. Okay, so where are we starting then with the fat quarter?
The patchwork is really easy. It's made with strips that we then cut up. So I'll need two strips of each colour. And because these are 1-inch squares. With the seam allowance on either side, that takes it to 1.5 inches. So I'll cut some 1.5 inch strips.
It's very, very intricate.
It's much easier than it looks. Small, there's a little bit of a trick.
Okay, then. So you're cutting a strip using the square ruler of... That ruler's 25 by 25, by the way. There it is at the bottom of your screen, £13.95. So how big, sorry, did you say you're making the strips?
They need to be 1.5 inches wide.
Because you want it finished at an inch, so you've got the 2/4 inch seam allowance.
Okay. By about 6.5. Just, I'll give myself a bit of extra to play with. Sorry, that's a bit... I've not started off well.
Do you want to start again? Hello,
yes, can we just
and welcome.
Rewind? There we go.
Okay.
Right. So I need two of these. I didn't straighten up the edge first, so no.
Oh, okay. Straighten now then.
There we go. So one of those. I'll do another one.
I'll do another one. Okay.
Is it, have it the right way round?
Yeah, but you could do it the other way as well, because it's the same all the way round, it's just your numbers are facing the right direction, aren't they, this way?
Yes. So I spin the mat.
Spin the mat round.
So I'm not posing a threat to anyone.
Straighten off the edge there. So you could do this, I mean, you could do more than, I mean, we're just showing you how, because it's quilting day, we're showing you patchwork and quilting day using the fat quarter, but of course, you could just use this fat quarter as to go in your stash, really.
Yes.
Because really, all those fabrics are going to be so usable, aren't they, and serviceable. Really, really lovely.
Nice for this time of year as well, they've got that sort of rich colour. Here we go, oh, this edge is straight. That helps things out.
So these are the two colours that we're going to be using, the kind of biscuit and the almost emerald green, that one, isn't it? Foresty emerald green, lovely. All from the plain... I don't know why they've called it plain, because the colours are lovely. Yes, they're plain fabrics, but they could have given it a lovely... Maybe we should think of a name for it. I'll think of one. Okay. Holly. Holly, if you've got a name for it, then please let us know. I just need that out of the way. It's £8.95, 0800 112 4433 if you want to ring the call centre. Now, you know what? You can send in a message straight through to the gallery, to the studio here. All you need to do is go to the website, www.sewingquarter.com. You press on Watch Live, and that's what you'll end up with there. You can, if you want to add something to your basket, that's your press live. If you want to add something to your basket, you just add it there where the arrow is at the moment. But if you scroll down the page, you'll be able to see a little box there that says Message the Studio. All you need to do is write your message in there. That's all Hannah writes. She just writes, hello. Oh, no, hello, Joe. Hello, Joe. Then if you also carry on scrolling down, look at this, that's all the pieces that we've had on sale all morning so far. So you can look up everything, the fabrics, the notions, the spray, everything there. Okay, we're ready to carry on then here now.
So I've got four strips, and yes. I'm just going to join them together to make a, well, it'll be a rectangle when I've finished.
Okay then, off you go.
Okay.
So you're doing them alternate, you could do them, oh no, there would be no point in doing them. Two same colour together because you just could cut a wider strip, couldn't you? But talking rubbish, ignore me. Hang on, I've got another message.
I use four different colours.
Oh, okay, that one's got four different colours in it there. That's really nice. I love that one. Right. Oh, okay, I understand. Hannah's had a message through saying, please just say everything in inches, feet and inches, not be feet, but in inches, in imperial. We have to do both by law. We have to mention both as much as we can by law. Because a lot of people, do you work in inches or do you centimetres?
Centimetres, really. You see, but I have to work in inches because quilting is in inches.
There you go, you see. Because if you look at the rulers on here, all the rulers have got inch increments on them, haven't they? So do you know what I mean? But we do have to say, you see that that's got inch squares on it there. We do have to say, so we know that quilters use, and patchworkers use inches mainly, don't they? I'm not saying everybody does at all, but mainly. But obviously, dressmakers now and everything use centimetres. It's all, but we, that's why we say both. That's why we have to say both to you. But thank you for your question. Daniel has messaged him.
Oh, isn't that, oh, Daniel, that was quick. He's mentioned, he's emailed in or messaged in with a name for this fat quarter. Woodland or forest? That's a brilliant one, Daniel. Thank you. Oh, that's the winner. But if you think you can beat Daniel, then let us know. Get a different. Choose. Oh, Robin Hood? Yeah, because you've got Will Scarlet. You got Will Scarlet. And then you got Robin Hood in the Lincoln Greens. There's Friar Tuck. Friar Tuck at the bottom. I don't know who else is in it. What's the others called? Little Big. That, I've said Maid Marian, haven't I? Did I say Maid Marian? Oh, I haven't said Maid Marian. Well, Maid Marian have to be in this colour here. Or the white. Maid. Maiden. Maid Marian. Mind, she'd get very dirty living in the woods if she wore white all the time, wouldn't she? Right, OK.
So I've joined those together.
Thank you, Daniel.
It's perfect for that bundle. Yes. Robin Hood. So I've joined those together along the length.
Now, if you're thinking, oh, she's not done those very evenly, it's because the ones in the middle have already had their seam allowances they taken have, up, haven't they? And on the ones sides. On the outside have still got their seam allowances sticking out there. So is this where you then press it? Do you want the ironing board cover thing?
Please, if that's about.
I know. It's time for the mini iron. This is fantastic, this is. I'd never seen one of these before, and that might be just my ignorance, because I was just trained using the big, heavy iron. But this is fantastic. It's like a mini iron. Now, when you buy it, it comes with that head on it. And what happens is the heat comes down here and concentrates in that kind of... Well, it's an iron shape, isn't it? Iron-shaped head there. You can get different attachments, which I'll go through in a second, but the mini iron itself is £49.95. And what you get in that kit is you do get the mini iron itself. Get the mini iron itself, but you also get the stand, which is there. You get the screwdriver, because you'll need the screwdriver to change the heads. But on the handle, I need to put my glasses on here, because on the handle of the mini iron, you have different... you've got high, low and off switch on the handle there. And you've also got this kind of casing around it, so you, because that obviously is going to get hot along there, so you can get that casing around that, so you're not going to... Well, you know, it protects your hands, doesn't it? It protects your hands. Right, so let's just watch how it works with this. It's fantastic for kind of fiddly, not really fiddly things, but intricate things.
Yes, really good. And the tip just helps to push the fabric out so you get a nice crisp. So I've done it on the back already. And with this, I want to press my seams to one side.
Press into the dark side.
Yes.
And also, because what would happen... If you've got your... I won't use the bigger... Oh, it is switched. It's off. So I'm not going to... Yeah, it's off. Right. Let me just show you. Right. If you were to use this, you either have to work like this with your finger very close to the edge to press it down. Or also, once you get through, you know what I mean? Don't worry, it's off. It's very difficult to do one little seam at a time. And then if you turn it over, you know what I mean? Whereas with the one that you're using, it's fantastic because the heat is just concentrated in one little area, isn't it?
Yes, and it's really easy with the big iron as well to distort the fabric slightly. If you move it while the iron's down, suddenly it's gone to move to one side a little bit.
Can I use this moment to talk about the other attachments? Would that be possible? Because This is the one that it comes with, right? The one that Joe's using at the moment is the one that it comes with. There is... So the iron itself is £49.95. Then if you look at the bottom of the screen... Oh, it's just disappeared. There is... That's the large adapter tip, right? £8.95. It's just like a larger version of the one that's on there at the moment, isn't it? So, that could be Robin Hood's arrow, I'm being told from the gallery now. That's interesting, isn't it? So that is £8.95. Then moving on, we've got this one, the slimline one. Brilliant if you're moving, not moving, making bias binding. Yep. Gorgeous. That, I'll just show it around it because it's a very, like a long, thin fish life. Oh, look, it says here, making Dolly's legs. Little Dolly's legs there. That's called the slimline tip. £8.95. And then last but not least, look at this one. This is fantastic if you make flowers or dollies. This one is called the Mini Iron Ball Adapter Tip. £8.95. Now, you had an idea about this morning, didn't you?
Yes.
Oh, you've already got one out.
I've got one. I'm making a small clutch bag at the moment with a curved bottom seam, and I think this would be perfect for pressing out the bottom seam in the bag to give it a real professional finish.
Yes, because you're not going to get your iron in there, are
you?
No,
not at all.
That's fantastic.
I think that would be ideal.
So these are the adapters here at £8.95, and then the iron that Joe's using is £49.95. That one comes with the attachment that Joe's been using there. I'll just show it to you again. With the little stand and with the screwdriver there. I'll just move it so it's, there you go, it's not blaring, there you go. To change the attachment, you see. That, what it is a screw at the top there. I'll touch on this one rather than that one, because that one's hot. You just unscrew the attachment, it slides out, and the new one slides in. OK, so you've pressed those open.
I have.
Shall I move this out of the way for you?
Well, thank you. And then with the square ruler, I'm just going to straighten off one edge and then cut some strips going in the opposite direction.
Again, at the inch and a half wide, yeah. So now, are you not worried then, when you've sewn a strip like this, now you're going to cut through the lines of stitching.
Mm-hmm.
Are you not worried that your stitching is going to unravel?
No, I tend to use a slightly shorter stitch length for things like this so that there are more stitches within the seam allowance. But because you will sew over these seams later, and then with quilting on top, it just holds it all together. It's...
Yeah.
There we go. So, measure.
Turn the match.
I'll do it this way.
Oh, we've had a couple of pictures in of people, quilts that people have made. OK, Kay and Mary, we've got your pictures of the quilts you've made. Hannah's saying they're absolutely gorgeous, but at the moment we can't figure out how we show them on the telly. So we'll just have to double check. That's all. But what we're saying is, if you send a picture into the gallery saying here's my picture, please put on it that we've got permission to show it on the television as well. Because I would hate to say, oh yes, here's a picture that Jo's made and the picture Jo's has, and you see how messy her bedroom is, and she complains in because her bedroom's all messy or something.
Yeah, I would always tidy up the bit that was in shot. The rest of it would be a mess.
Oh, right. But are you happy for
the photo of my bedroom, yeah. There we go. Right, so I've got four strips now. And because the seams are pressed in one direction, when we turn these round...
They'll never get back together, will they?
They won't, no. I think they've had their day. Oh. There we go. And because the seams go in opposite directions where they join, that helps to get the points lined up.
Yes.
Because they nest... I'll show the side. They sort of jigsaw together. They nest together naturally. They
nest or nestle?
Nestle. I think nestle's nice, isn't it? They should just fall together. Even the presser foot will help to push them together like that. So hopefully...
OK, before you do that, I'm just going to show that to the camera again. So what you do is you line up your seams... like that, and then you nest. I've gone very echoey. Is it because I'm talking near your microphone?
Oh, should I move away?
Let me just test it. And it just nestles in each of the seams. That's it. Because you've got one seam allowance going that way and one seam allowance going that way, then okay, right. Shall we move on?
Okay.
Was that because I was standing too close? I think I could hear myself down your microphone then.
Do we need to keep our distance?
Oh, that's a shame. Or they get some decent microphones in. That's what they could do.
Okay.
So you're not pinning again?
No, I'm just going for.
Do many patchworkers pin, or do they just once they get experienced? They just.
I think once they get experienced, pins go out of the window a bit, just because it takes more time. If you want to get a quilt done quickly, yes, the. Time spent pinning tends to be the one that goes.
Oh, now Kay sent a picture of her quilting. Oh, she had some quilting on a little bag. Oh, look!
That's beautiful. Look
at the quilting. The fat quarters were... The fat quarters, Kay said the fat quarters, that was lovely, just got a glimpse of your bag, there it is. So the fat quarters would be lovely as the lining for that. Are they chickens? Are they fat chickens? Oh, gorgeous, aren't they? Isn't that lovely? Okay, that's lovely. You've got a little plant in that picture as well there, haven't you? That's gorgeous. Thank you, Kay. That's beautiful. Thank you. And Tony, any pictures you want us to show, send them in. But please put on it that we've got permission to show it on the television. That's all.
Okay, so they've lined up. I'll carry on and join the remaining two strips.
Yeah, put them together.
Crack on with that.
Because we've just made a baby cot quilt, which was we had trouble pushing under the machine, and now we've got like baby patchwork, which is kind of looks very tiny compared to it. Do you remember that the fabric that Jo's using is from the plain 8-piece fat quarter bundle, £8.95, which Daniel has called woodland or forest, and then Michael called it Robin Hood, or just call it Sherwood Forest. That's what you could call it, Sherwood Forest, couldn't you? It'd be nice. Lady Audrey's from near there. Okay, so we're just measuring all four of these together.
Yes.
I've just realised what it is. Your microphone's pointing towards me. That's why everyone's hearing me at home.
Is that
the problem?
We'll
sort that out afterwards, don't worry. Stitch in a colour. I mean, I know you're stitching in the white there, but would you normally stitch in a colour? I just suppose it's a bit difficult, really, because if you've got lots of different colours, how do you choose which colour you're going to stitch it all together in?
I tend to go for the palest colour and match to that one. Otherwise, if you go for a darker thread, it shows up more strikingly against the paler fabrics than it does against the others.
Is this what you're looking for?
That is.
Getting in tune with each other now, aren't we? Right, this is the mini iron. This is fantastic. I'm just going to step back because I can hear myself in your microphone. This is the mini iron there, the Clover Mini Iron 2. Oh, no, hang on. Oh, yeah, it's called the adapter. That's not the adapter. That's what the iron is called. That's its name, like the Revenge of. This one's called the Avenger. Not Avenger, adapter. I'm getting carried away there, thinking we were in Hollywood again. £49.95. I mean, some people, this place is Hollywood, isn't it, Timothy? £49.95. Just look at the way. Just describe what it's like to use that iron.
It's great. It really does. I mean, I've not applied too much pressure, and it's really held those seams open. And it just means I'm not catching. Often with a big iron, you sort of end up hooking one over that you've already pressed or that you're about to press. So you can just do them one at a time. The star patchwork with the diamonds I was doing before, it'd be perfect for that as well.
Oh, yes.
Pressing all those
seams
open. It's really lightweight as well and easy to use.
But it's obviously got a lot of heat behind it because it's really just ironing those squares out perfectly, isn't it? That seam allowance out perfectly.
Oh, it's no problems at all.
That's the bottom graphic for the mini iron there, the £49.95. The fabric that Jo's using is the plain, well, we've called it Sherwood Forest, the Woodland, the Robin Hood bundle, we've renamed it. But when you get through to the call centre, it's called the plain, yes, don't say that to the call centre, I get very confused. Plain 8 fat bundle quarter, £8.95. So, this is what we're working towards. Oh, so
we have the checkerboard. Patchwork done now, that's the patchwork finished.
If you've got baby chess pieces or baby drafts, you could play, you know, drafts. If you could make your placemat this size, it could be a drafts board or a chess board, couldn't it?
Yeah.
So what's the next stage then?
The next stage, we want to get it to this point.
Oh, and we'll have one here I've already done.
I know. I do enjoy the. Here's one I made earlier.
Yes,
moments.
Exactly. So now I notice that your wadding and your backing fabric are actually bigger than your.
You would always have them larger overall than your patchwork, but in this instance, I've made the backing quite a bit bigger because it needs to be trimmed down, and then this is eventually what's folded over to form the sides.
I thought it was bound. Okay. So these are all fabrics out of this fat quarter, aren't they?
They are. Using
it? Yes.
So at this point,
yes.
I'll try to stop catching the iron. Yeah. Put your backing fabric wrong side up.
Yes.
And then your Wadding.
How much bigger have you cut the... Does it matter how much bigger you cut the bottom, the backing fabric, to make the binding to go around the edge?
I just did a couple of inches.
Okay.
I mean, you'll see in a minute how much needs to be trimmed off. You could get away with less, but about that.
Okay.
It's fine. So, and then it would be a case of quilting it, which I've done with this one already.
Okay. Would you pin it? Would you baste it? Would you spray it?
Because it's so small, I wouldn't baste it. I don't think there's much need, but actually a bit of spray baste will always help.
You can quilt it wherever you wanted, couldn't you? But you've chosen to do. Now, again, do you always start in the centre?
With something this size, you can get away with not doing this. It's not like a full size quilt. Okay. You might encounter a bit of problem, but you can keep it stretched out with your hands just under the foot. It shouldn't be a problem.
Okay, then.
So that's what I did with those.
If you did want to use the spray adhesive, it's been put away, but it's there. It's that brilliant spray, £7.95, just to stick them together. OK, so, are you not going to show us how you've done it, then?
I'm too chicken to quilt on screen.
Oh, OK.
Well, it means changing the foot.
Oh, of course. All right, so then, much I'll let you off. Because we're more interested in the binding. And we've got to get... Also, we've got to get them to the sunglasses. We've got to. Don't worry, I'm not rushing. You've got plenty of time. But it's the binding that's interesting on this one, isn't it?
It is. So at this point, when you quilt, you want to leave a border around. You don't want to go right up to the edges, because for this point now, we'll fold the backing fabric, which will be the binding back. Just give it a little pin to keep it out of the way.
Right.
And then
nice
square ruler.
Square ruler. 25 by 25 centimetres or 10 inches square.
Right,
I see why you've pinned I couldn't figure out why you pinned the fabric back, because you don't want to obviously slice through your background fabric, do you?
And I have done that.
What, now?
No, not now.
Oh, in the past?
Yes, in the past. So.
Well, you learn by your mistakes, don't you? That's
you
like
do.
Our Hayley, our production manager, Hayley, learned by her mistakes. She had to do a very long car journey yesterday to get things for the show that she'd forgotten to book for us. She'll be listening in the other room.
I did a very long car journey the other day as well.
Do what?
I did a very long car journey the other day as well, but I know now the turning I definitely need to.
Oh, no, there's nothing worse, is there? It's like that on the motorway when I'm going home on the motorway. If I miss my junction, the next one, there's no other little one to come off. You go...
Yeah.
So you're just cutting this to...
Just trimming the wadding to the size
of the patchwork.
So
now, is it still called a patchwork at this point, or is it a quilt now because you've gone through the three layers? Or is it a quilt?
It's a quilt. Patchwork quilt. It's quilted now.
Because I didn't know that. I didn't realise that the quilting was I thought the bed cover was called a quilt because it was patchwork, not because of the quilting. Yeah.
I thought the same, actually. It was I didn't realise that they... refer to two different processes.
Yes, yeah. You do now.
I do now.
That's your career.
Yes. So there we go.
Do you do much quilting on your... Because your main job is as a soft toy designer. Do you use much quilting in making your toys, now that you're a quilter as well? Do you think, I could do this bit?
I do. I like to combine the two and add quilting wherever possible. I did a bunny yesterday and that had quilted ears. And the sausage dog we made... was sort of a combination of the two,
body. Yes, it was. Of course it was.
I do. I like any excuse to combine the two.
Yes, I've got the sausage dog draft extruder in my bag at the moment. So, right.
So we've trimmed down the wadding, and now we want to trim down the backing, so it's the right size for folding. And I've gone for 3/4 of an inch, so I line up the points on there. Unfortunately, I've chosen to do red backing fabric.
And the ruler's got red lines on it.
It's got red lines on it.
We had a ruler the other day that was yellow and black lines on a ruler the other day.
I'll just take
that. You can still see it. It's just... So you're making it 3/4 of an inch from the edge...
From the edge of the patchwork.
Of the patchwork.
Yep.
3/4 of an inch. What's that in centimetres, Hannah?
About 9 millimetres.
It's what?
Is it 9 millimetres?
Is it? I knew how I could tell Hannah wasn't concentrating.
So. Trying to catch her off guard.
She was looking up a song she's going to sing later, getting the notes
right. Oh, no, 9 millimetres isn't right at all. It's 6, 8,
Well, 3/4 of an inch is...
A quarter...
What we like. Right, hang on. So 1 inch is 2.5 centimetres. So what did you just say? 3/4 of an inch would be half of that plus a quarter. So that's 2.5. So that's 1 1/4 plus 1.9 centimetres. What did you say?
Well, I use 1/4 of an inch or a 6 millimetre seam allowance. So it's 3/6, would be about...
Yeah, 1.8. Yeah. We got there. We got there eventually.
Converting from one to the other is not my strong point. So they're trimmed down, and now I'm going to do some ironing again.
Oh, sorry. I wasn't in tune that time. I was too busy watching, wasn't I? There you go.
Now we start with the corners.
Yep.
You want to fold in the backing fabric so it meets the edge of the patchwork.
Mm-hmm.
Give that a press. And then fold it over again at that point. Give that press.
Now we're using again the Clove Mini Iron to the adapter. 49 pounds. Oh, sorry, that sounds a bit frightening. I didn't mean it to be frightening at all. I was trying to do the Hollywood voice, you know. I'll show it to you while you're ironing that other corner. Here we go. This is the Clove Mini Iron to the adapter. You get all of that for £49.95. I'll go through all the attachments you get. You can buy to go with it, but that's what you get for £49.95. So, you've turned the corner in and in again.
In and in again, yes. So, folded it in, point to point,
yeah,
and then folded it over again, so it just covers the
end. Oh, so it just covers the corner, not... Okay, got it. Mind your fingers.
Get it even. And it's great because it really holds the fabric. It really does fix the crease in place.
Yes, you've done that on all four corners.
All four corners. And then you want to fold the sides just in so they meet the edge.
So you've now turned the straight edges to meet the patchwork.
Yes. Yeah. Should I turn it around that way? So yeah.
Yes. Whichever way they're capturing your every move using that gorgeous mini iron. £49.95. Now remember, no matter how many pieces you buy during the day, whether it's the mini iron, whether it's the fabric, whether it's a rotary cutter, whether it's pins, you pay £2.95 post and packaging per day. It all gets consolidated at midnight, so you can check out as many times as you like. You're not going to be charged that extra £2.95. 0800 112 4433 is the phone number. Give the call centre a call if you get confused. Oh, now, what are you doing at the corner there?
I'm just folding the last edge over.
Oh, OK. And is the next thing sewing?
Yes.
Right, OK. Because before we go to the sewing machine... Oh, no, it's got to iron.
Just
a bit
fold
more.
This over again and then Sorry. We'll stitch, because these then should form mitered corners.
You're using this iron an awful lot for this project, aren't you?
Fiddly things like this, it really is perfect. This would be difficult, well, this is difficult with a full size iron. I wouldn't recommend it with a full size iron, but this is just the job.
With a big iron, you'd definitely be in the threat of burning your iron, but, you know, please be as careful as you can.
I always have the steam setting on by accident, and then suddenly it...
Pssh!
Yes.
So what are you doing at the corner there?
So the corners, so they should come together like that.
Mm-hmm.
Just fold them over. And give them a little press in with the iron. Try and get them into more
so
of
now,
a point.
So now, you're the one that's using that iron. There's not... I know it's hot to press the iron, but can you feel the heat is, you know, like on your fingers?
It's not too bad on the fabric. You can touch the fabric pretty much as soon as you've pressed it.
That's a song, isn't it? I feel it in my fingers. I feel it in my toes. Yeah, no, I can't sing. Thank you very much indeed. Everyone's holding their ears in the gallery.
And just give it a good press.
Oh, that's a good one.
And then I'll continue round, do the rest, then. And then shall I pin those?
Yep, while you do that, have we got a picture of Fiona's, did you say? Oh, what? A quilted mug rug Fiona's made. Oh, I love the quilting.
Oh, that's nice.
Is that, what's a mug rug then? Is that the same as a coaster? Should we take the graphics out just so we can have a look at it properly? Is that possible? I like that. I like the way you've used triangles there on that one. It looks like it's a pointy one, isn't it? But that's nice. So do you think that's big enough just for... Oh, I was busy having a look then, wasn't I? I'll look on the other screen at the bottom there. Do you think it's big enough for one mug, or do you think you can fit four mugs on there? So it's like a coaster. Mug rug. Oh, that's a nice idea. I've never... Oh, that's perfect, Fiona. Large enough for a mug and a couple of biscuits. Only a couple. right, while you're pressing that, I've got a little film that I need to show you. And it's just so you can get to know us here at Sewing Quarter a little bit better. Have a look at this.
Here at the Sewing Quarter, we want to bring our viewers the best and most exciting opportunities to learn and expand your knowledge. To help do this, we will be bringing in some of the leading industry experts in sewing and quilting to help guide our viewers along the way. Such as Jennifer Taylor, Samantha Claridge, Lucy Brennan, Joe Carter, Angela Atwood, Karen Lewis, Rebecca Reed, and finally, Jenny Fox Proverbs, who is the senior editor of Today's Quilter and Love Patchwork and Quilting magazines.
Hello, welcome back. See, that was interesting. All the designers that are joining us, it's fantastic. They've all come on board with us. Anyway, I want to take you through the Fat Quarters and the two books I've got here available today. It's Quilting Day. Remember, it is Quilting Day here at Sewing Quarter. We are the channel totally dedicated to everything sewing. Really, really lovely. Now, I'm going to show you, I'll show you a still of this for the time being. We're going to start off with the one that we have named Sherwood Forest or Forest. Daniel called it Forest or Woodland. Someone else called it Robin Hood. Aren't they lovely, those colours there? It's £8.95 for a plain 8-piece fat quarter. Bundle. It's £8.95. You get lots of beautiful colours in there, don't you? You get the maroon at the bottom or the plum. You get the red. You get the forest green. You get the emerald green. You get the spring green. You get a lovely kind of bluey grey. You get gorgeous biscuit, and then you've got that like buttermilk at the top there. It's fantastic because all those colours are going to be amazing, aren't they? As your for your stash, even if you haven't got a project that you're ready to use them for, they could go in your stash, couldn't they? So that one there is the one that's called the plain. Right, now moving on, I've got the rose one next. We saw this earlier, but a few of you would like to see it. Look at the beautiful colours here. You could use this is you could use any of these for the coasters or anything really, for any of your stash, backs of cushions or anything. Really, really lovely colours. Now this one is £9.95. It's lovely, isn't it? It's the rose 8-piece fat quarter at £9.95. Really lovely colours in there. Oh, actually, I can show you through the colours. I can show you through the colours on here. Look, look, that's a lovely Victorian tea rose colour. That one. On the top there. That's lovely, isn't it? Then you've got that fabulous bright pink there, almost a fuchsia pink there. Then you've got the, that's a lovely, rich, expensive looking pink, that one, isn't it? Oh, kind of peachy. Then you've got the baby pink with the peach tint. Oh, candy floss. I was about to say morganite. It's the colour of morganite, that one is, yeah? Then we've got the biscuit colour there, the gorgeous, gorgeous oatmeal-y, biscuity colour. Cream. Now, you see, now, yes, exactly. Oops, that there, if you saw that on a roll in a shop, you'd go, I don't want that brown, really. Soon as you team it with any of these other colours, look at those three together. Oh, what's that ice cream where you get vanilla, chocolate, and strawberry, Neapolitan. It's like a Neapolitan ice cream. Ice cream, that one, isn't it? Then we've got the lovely ivory cream there and then the pure white on the bottom. So that one there is the rose. That one is the rose one there. Okay, now we'll move on to... Here we go, the iris one. This one's called Iris. Again, look at the bundle you get there. Really lovely, gorgeous bundle with all the different colours in there. £9.95. Now, this is the one that Joe used for the table runner earlier. That's lovely, isn't it? And I'll go through the colours for that one for you. We've got this kind of, what'd you say, kingfisher? Aquamarine-y kind of blue there. That's a lovely colour, isn't it? Traditional navy. Then I call that one the iris. That one's the iris. Or amethyst. Amethyst, that's a beautiful. Or iolite. I like iolite. Then got this, that beautiful crushed plum. Crushed plum, that one. Excuse me. Then we've got this lovely kind of grey. Now, again, you see, that's one of those fabrics where you'd go, oh, I don't know if I'm going to buy that if you bought it in a shop. But look at those three, colours. Together, they look fabulous together, don't they? Really lovely. So that's the blue. And then underneath that, we've got the lovely baby blue there. And then we've got the white at the bottom. Always have the white at the bottom, don't they, on these for some reason? Oh, I could turn it up and it'd be the right white would be on the top, wouldn't it? And then last but not least, look at this. This one is called Winter Berries. I've got no idea why, because I'd call that spring berries myself. Or almost rainbow. That's lovely, isn't it? And again, I'll take you through the different colours. Oh, that one hasn't got white. So I haven't got white on the bottom of that one because it hasn't got white in that one. Flame. I'd say that one had got flame there. Then you've got the apricot and peach, the two apricot and peach tones. Then you've got sunshine, lemon yellow there, mimosa yellow there. This is lovely. That's a gorgeous spring green, isn't it, that one? Really lovely spring green there. Then you've got almost like a jade green there. Then we've got, that's a beautiful one, isn't it? That's a fabulous, fabulous Sherwood forest green there. Oh, no, actually, and then there's that one. That one's more forest green, isn't it? But really, that's got more of a, when you see it together, that's got more of a blue in it, hasn't it? And then you've got that lovely green. £9.95 again for the fat quarter bundle. Now, I'll just tidy the table up now before I go back. Oh, of course, somebody's asked about the books, aren't they? I've just had this. Right, now, I've got this book here, which I've not even shown you yet. This... It's lovely, isn't it? Look at this little book here. Well, I say little. It's the Encyclopedia of Quilting and Patchwork Techniques. Because jelly rolls on the front there. It's really lovely. Look at all the details you need to know. And then I'll just flick through it for you. Oops. Oh, I love... Oh, Joe, I'd like one of those, please, when you've got time. The book is £12.95. All the techniques you need to know, all about quilting. Oh, that's an unusual one. That's an unusual one, isn't it? Right, hang on a sec, let me have a look. Right. Look. Isn't that lovely? All different techniques there. All the different names. Oh, lots of the patches have different names. Don't ask me to name them, I haven't got my glasses on at the moment. But this is the Encyclopedia of Quilting and Patchwork Techniques. It's by Catherine Goodyear. Oh, I hope I'm saying her name right now. £12.95. I'll carry on flicking through because there's all sorts of technique. Oh, well, it covers all sorts of things from the basics right the way through to the more cop. Oh, that's nice. Is that like a rainbow? That's fancy, isn't it? That one. But look, everything you need to know. Oh, about. And there are lots of. I love that one. That's like a cathedral window, isn't it, that one? Oh, is that a window? Is that inspiration? I'm just going to look at the book. No, it's a quilt. It's a quilt by a lady called Jenny. I was trying to read it. Looks like a stained glass window, doesn't it? That is a patchwork quilt. Oh, I might have to give her a call later. Nice, isn't it? Oh, look, and there's Joseph's coat. Amazing coloured coat on the one bit next to it. That's what a lovely book. What a lovely book with all. It's carrying on. I'm still going. It's good. Now that would be great as it. I love these. Oh, look at that one. Look at that one there. Face there. They're fantastic. £12.95. I'm sorry, but if you love something, you should get excited about it. They're all shouting at me now for going overboard about it. How much is it? £12.95. I love it. £12.95. Oh, well, I'll buy it. I'll pay for it. Don't worry. I'll just put it in my trolley. Okay, so, Jo, what have you done while I've not been here?
I've just been ironing, pressing.
ironing, because we are using the mini iron to the adapter here today. The adapter. It's a fantastic... before I came here, I'd never, ever seen one of these before. What a fantastic gadget. Not even a gadget, is it? It's just brilliant. The mini iron sat at £49.95. I love it. So you've been using that to go around the edges with your binding, which is actually the background fabric you brought round.
Come around the sides, yes, to form the binding on the front.
Okay.
So I've just pressed that in place and I can just concentrate on the binding itself. I don't need to press the quilted area and lose some of its...
No, of course not. And then you just top stitch around there, would you?
Yes.
I'm not going to ask you to do that because we've got sunglasses or glasses.
We have. We need to move on, don't we?
And I love this, and because I want one of these. So we'll work out how this one works because that's a different kind of quilting on that, isn't it?
It is. I've pre-quilted a piece.
Oh.
These are.
So these are from the fat quarter.
They are.
Yeah, and you've. Stitch three pieces together.
So two rectangles measuring 5 inches by 8.5. Right. So they're saying 5 inches by 8.5. And this is 5 inches by 2 inches. This will form.
Oh, okay. So look, so that's
fold
three,
at the top.
So what it is you have that as your solid colour as this. You say you have that solid colour there for that. And then on top of that, you have whatever colour you want as you fold over. And then at the other end, you have the colour of your main colour on the other side.
Yes, and yeah. I quilted this really simply by just doing wavy lines up and down. And because it's not large, I started at one end, I think I started here, and then would turn and come back the other way. Get away with it on something this size. And there's no backing fabric either. It was straight onto some wadding.
Did you use a special foot for that?
I didn't even switch to the walking foot. So you could do this. It's easier with a walking foot, but you can do it with just a regular standard machine foot.
That's interesting, isn't it? It looks fascinating.
It's okay. So simple, but it does give a really nice effect.
Yes. So now, did you have to measure? Where are my glasses? Did you measure anything before you started making them? Or did you just guess?
I have quite big sunglasses, so I just used my large sunglasses. So if you have smaller glasses, you could just make it to fit the size of glasses you want.
Yes, exactly.
But mine are great big.
Oh, yeah, that's perfect for my glasses. Okay, so the next stage is
you want to line the fold over at the top. And the lining for the actual body of the sunglasses case are just rectangles that are the same size. So 8.5 by 5 for those. So I'll put the lining to one side.
Okay.
And then you want to add the lining for the fold over just across the top there.
So this is the bit you're doing here. You're lining that fold over bit at the top there.
It's just a simple envelope fold across the top. I'll do that. Oh, I'm using my other foot to press the machine presser foot. It could all go wrong.
You're doing what?
I'm using my other foot. I'm using my left foot. I never use my left foot.
What is that?
I don't know.
I thought you meant this foot then. I was going, no
my
that's
actual...
the same foot, your actual foot on the pedal underneath the table.
But it worked out.
Yeah.
And so at this point, I would use... You don't want this to show.
No, because that's this bit here that we're doing, the inside bit of there.
So you could just run the mini iron along there.
The mini iron, which is £49.95, the adapter. Lots of you coming in for the iron. Lots of you coming in for the iron.
It'd also be great if you did foundation paper piecing, because that's just a series of seams you have to press after you've done each one.
Oh, okay.
It would be perfect for that. So I'm just going to top stitch along there just to keep that fold in place.
So you've top stitched, okay, so that's now, you're stitching now here.
Yes, I'm doing that
on the actual
one,
thing.
The
this is where you're stitching here on the actual thing. Just stitching that. So is that so the lining doesn't roll round when you've...
Yes, just to keep it all neat.
So you can do this in any of the colours, really. If you've got any of the fat quarters or you know, like if you bought the rose one or the winter berries one, you can make a really brightly coloured. I'd have to make it bright. If it's at the bottom of my bag to find it, I'd have to kind of have a bright one, sadly, in these early mornings. I know, it's old age for you. When you get to 39, you'll know what it's like.
I am 39.
No, shut So am I. Isn't that funny?
It's what a coincidence.
I didn't look at different. I've obviously had a very hard life. So, next.
Next, you want to sew the sides together and so use
what
the
seams. So what looks like a complicated construction actually isn't complicated.
It's really simple. Yeah.
So we sew the side seams together.
Sew the side seams together. So that folds at the seam there.
Yes.
And then this folds in like this.
Oh, right. Hang on again. Just do that again.
It folds on the seam.
Yes.
I'll give it a little pin. I can't because I've used all my pins.
You've got the pins, I've not got them.
Pinch them out of there. So it folds where the envelope fold is. Do the same on that side.
So that's this bit, which you just folded into. Yeah, okay, folds into itself, and now you're going to sew down the sides.
So this folded area of the envelope, the top of the envelope, shouldn't meet the top. You should be sewing. It doesn't matter if you catch it, but you should be sewing when you add the lining.
Yes.
Just inside. But I'll sew down each side, just quickly.
So you're going from the fold upwards then, not from the seam downwards. Yes, here, you're starting at the fold at the bottom of the bag.
Although it doesn't matter which way, okay, whichever way you feel more comfortable.
And again, what sort of seam allowance are you leaving there?
I generally work with a quarter inch seam allowance, but with this, you could add a little bit more if you want, because the mini iron is perfect for little bag projects, things you can't get an iron into. So you see it will fold over later,
yes,
so that's
one side. Yes, got it.
So I'll just...
It's just because I wouldn't have thought about that, but it's just thinking it through, isn't it? Each stage through slowly, don't rush ahead and get it, you just got to. But this is, actually, if you think about it, it's obvious, but it's just one of those techniques you just have to remember, that when you're bagging through or lining, that you just put that everything that's going to be on the outside needs to be on the inside almost,
yes,
isn't it, when you're stitching it together.
So I'll quickly do this one. Go a bit slowly here because I know there's a pin in it.
Okay. Oh.
Now this attachment for the mini iron would be great for pressing these seams open. See, it would just run.
Yes. I could pretend, couldn't I? It's not hot.
You could. And there's a lower heat setting on there if you were worried about catching the wadding and melting it at all. I mean, you could use a cloth to cover
it.
Or you could just use the lower heat setting and
exactly,
that long, thin one.
This is the adapter we're showing there. It's the Clover, I'll just put it in shot, the Clover adapter slimline tip, which you can add to the iron itself, the mini iron itself. That's the iron, £49.95. This is the adapter, £8.95. I'll show it to you in the packet there. This is how you'll get it there. It's very good for bias binding, for pressing out little seams like that, and also for little dolly socks. Okay.
So I've just turned it out the right way, just so you can see.
But right.
With a normal iron, you can't get inside...
No.
..small spaces at all. I mean, I'd press it from this side. So... clutch bags and purses and things like that, it would be ideal.
Well, especially like saying on the clutch bag you're making, the ball tip, what's it called, the adapter ball tip, that would be a brilliant one, wouldn't it?
It would. So I could just fit it inside and just press along the seam.
That's fantastic, isn't it?
Should I add the lining quick? How
yeah, I was going to say, all right, you've got to wait a couple of minutes, but how would you add the lining into that then?
I would have this one the right way out. And I would join these together along the sides, leave the bottom open. Have we got time for me to do that quickly?
Yeah, go on,
I'll give it a go. I'll boost the speed of
the machine. Well, because you're just doing two straight stitches there.
I am.
Two straight seams. So I just a lot of people asking about the iron. £49.95 for the gorgeous mini iron to the adapter. So it does come with that. Oh, I won't point it with that. It does come with this adapter already in it and the little screwdriver there. £49.95, the main one that Joe's been using. But you can buy three different adapters for it, which put along the bottom there. The large one, first of all, there. So same thing, but just slightly larger, £8.95. Then we've got the slimline one that we just saw. That one is called the slimline, £8.95. And then if you do crafting, making flowers, or indeed making little clutch bags, which Joe said would be brilliant for just ironing out that inside seam there, that one is the mini iron ball adapter tip, £8.95. Okay, so what you're doing is you're just putting your right sides together.
I am. I've left the bottom open so I can bag it out later.
That's
it,
yeah.
And you would just sew, trying not to catch the envelope fold. Just sew around here,
yeah,
to join it. And then you'd use the iron. It'd be great for pressing out this seam and just making sure that lies nice and flat. Should I?
You can carry on. I'm going to tell you about the book. Lots of people asking about the encyclopedia. I'll link the message in. Oh, Linda, thank you, my love. She's enjoying my enthusiasm and excitement. And your tutorial, it's been called a tutorial demonstration, invaluable, but what? Easy to follow, easy to understand. Thank you, Linda, my love. Thank you for that. I won't get so excited this time, but this book is gorgeous. The Encyclopedia of Quilting and Patching. I do love this book. I'm going to buy this. 0800 112 4433, give us a call. Go to sewingquarter.com. It's just full of all the techniques and everything like that. Beautiful, fabulous as a gift as well. I'm going to keep it on the desk because I'm carrying on with quilting in the next hour, quilting day. Now, Angela is back. We're going to go for a short break. Angela is back. We're going to be making a patchwork quilted book cover. But for the time being, thanks ever so much for coming
in. Thank you.
That's almost done. It's almost done. Just push it through there.
Pop the lining through. And then pop your glasses in.
There we go. Use that lovely little glasses case there where we've used the mini iron. If you've got any questions, just ring the call centre. Thank you ever so much indeed, Jo.
Oh, thank you.
Don't go anywhere. I'll be back in 3 minutes with Angela and we'll be doing a quilted book cover. Go nowhere.
My name is Angela Atwood and I'm a free motion embroiderer, a textile artist and a quilter and a tutor. Well, I started life as a graphic designer. I went to art school and had 20 years in graphic design, but always sort of played with a sewing machine. I'm very like tactile, so I'd always messed about with making things. And then a number of years ago, just decided actually I'd like to make that my new career. So went off and studied City and Guilds in textiles to switch career. My favourite things I like to make are textile art pieces, although I have to say in the last couple of years I've become very hooked on patchwork and quilting. One nice tip that I was always given was when threading a needle, lots of us are there forever trying to thread a needle, is actually to take the needle to the thread, not a bendy bit of thread to a needle. The favourite items that I've made are a couple of different things actually. My favourite items from my textile art is the Birmingham piece. This is a piece inspired by Birmingham architecture and it actually embodies my free motion embroidery, my textile art and my quilting all in one piece. The Budlier is what clients seem to think is their favourite, But my most favourite thing to cuddle up in is my sofa quilt. So there's a few of my favourite things I've made. I think this will expand the sewing industry. Sewing had gone so out of fashion a number of years ago until the likes of the Sewing Bee brought making back into fashion. Quilting's always been there, a bit underground. The quilting ladies have been quilting away secretly when everything else went out of fashion. So there's more and more young people coming back to sewing, which is great.
Sewing Quarter is at the very heart of sewing as we bring you all things sewing and quilting. The team behind us live and breathe sewing day to day. We strive to bring you exclusive offers, exciting live demonstrations, and most importantly, we will custom cut fabric to your specification in our very own cutting room. We will also be bringing you TV exclusives that you won't be able to find anywhere else. So come and join us today at the Sewing Quarter.
Welcome to the Sewing Quarter!
When you spend £10 on your first purchase, you will receive this free sewing kit from the Sewing Quarter worth £14.99.
Hello, welcome back. Now, this isn't in this show, this is just from the last show. I need to tell you, the panel, the jungle panel, has nearly sold out. So if you want the jungle panel, please give the call centre a ring straight away. 0800 112 44 33. It has nearly gone. And they're just getting me an update. Oh, there it is, sorry. At £6.95. You get it as the panel. It's a little bit creased because we weren't expecting to get it back out again. But it's almost sold out. And I didn't, if you were thinking, oh, I'll add that to my basket later, I didn't want anyone to miss out because it's nearly gone. And while you're on the phone, I'd also check up about the elephant fabric as well, because that's either sold out or it's nearly sold out as well. You know, the one that Angie used as the backing. Right. So, no undue pressure there at all, but I would hate it if you rang up in an hour's time, so I'll have one of those panels, please, and they said, oh, we sold out and we hadn't given you any warning. It was just to that. Here you go, Amy. Thank you ever so much indeed. Now, say that again, Hannah. I didn't understand that. Yes. Sorry about this. I've got no idea what she's saying. So we'll carry on. Welcome back. Andy's back. We're going to be making the most gorgeous... Well, it's here. I normally open the show reading her book, don't I? Because she brings her diary in and I read through it like this, but she's brought just an empty book now. Anyway, isn't it gorgeous? Now, I've got an exclusive. We have an exclusive of these Dashwood Fat Quarters. Now, you might have seen these fabrics for sale in the Dashwood, from Dashwood, but we are the only people to bring you a fat quarter made up of these fabrics. Aren't they gorgeous? It's called Paper Meadow, 8-piece fat quarter, £19.95. Let me just show you the fat quarter. I'll go around here because I've got it. Oh, I can do it here. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. We love these fabrics. What I'll do is I'll go over to Angie and we'll get started on the show, and then I'll go through each of the fabric, because each fabric, I mean, you just feel it. Just feel it. The quality is out of this world. But 100% cotton. But obviously, I'll go through all the patterns with you in a minute, because they're all really, really gorgeous patterns. Now, that is the fat quarter. We've teamed these lovely solids with it, because Angie's used the white on her book cover, but you could use any of these colours. Or if you don't like these colours, there are plenty of them on our website. The white one here is so popular. It's really, really... The other day, we had this white fabric on, and so many people, not buying it for the project they were doing it, but saying they were buying it for their stash. That is the Spectrum Solid Makoa in white, 0.5 metre, £3. It's such good quality. It's such good quality for £3.25. Now, remember, we sell our fabrics in 0.5 metre increments. When you buy fabric, right, when you buy this fabric, it comes arrived, and it's just the fabric. It comes in the most beautiful box with tissue paper around it and everything. So that's the white one. Then we've got... Oh, right now, I like this word, right? I like the word this is called. Look, it's called putty. I like that name. Hannah's got something against putty, but because it sums it up exactly, because you've got beige and you've got pink in there. It's really, really lovely. That Now, all of these colours do appear in the Dashwood exclusive. I'll show you in a second, anyway. And then, last but not least, in the solids. I want to keep going because this book cover's gorgeous. Last but not least, here is the coral. Coral colour. Again, the Spectrum Solid by Macro in coral, half a metre for £3.25. All really, really gorgeous colours. Right, now I'm going to go over there, but I've got to walk all the way around, I'm afraid, because I can't get through. But I'll go through this way. When I come back, I'll talk about those two books as well, because they're fantastic, those two books. Hello, you.
Yeah.
Right.
We're back.
Let's make one of these, because I love it. I love it.
The fabrics are gorgeous, aren't they? They're just stunning. So when Sewing Quarter sent me this bundle...
Yes.
...the thing that jumped out to me was that I wanted to pair it with white, as you've said.
Yes.
Really lovely and fresh. And they spoke to me to do half-square triangles.
Half-square triangles. Now, that's quite an art, isn't it? But also, I want to point out, did you use all... a bit of every single fabric?
Yes, I have. There's 8 fabrics in the bundle, so I've used all 8 fabrics and just paired it with a white. So that's what we're going to work on.
Because I love it.
On each of the front and the back, there's 16 squares.
Yes.
So that's what we've used. So there's 4 of the fabrics on the front and 4 on the back.
Or the other way around, if you want to do the other way around. Yeah. I just love the way that all the fabrics blend beautifully together,
don't
they?
It's gorgeous, yep. Really.
Okay,
lovely.
So let's look. So can I take that off the book?
Yes.
I'll just take it off the book so I can show you exactly what it is we're
making.
We've
used one of the fabrics inside for the backing. So this is for an A5 notebook cover, sketchbook, or diary.
Yeah.
Anything like that, but you can use the technique to make it for any size book.
I was going to say, if you've got an A4 diary that you write everything in every night or whatever, not giving anything away there, or you've got a little notepad that you take everywhere with you, you can make it to whatever size you want it to be.
That's
so
right.
How did you start?
So, firstly, this is a little bit more advanced. I thought it'd be really nice to show the viewers if they've never made half square triangles before. So, this is a really nice way of playing around with half square triangles.
Because to me, before I won't interrupt once you start,
that's
I promise.
Okay.
Half square triangle is half a square. Do you know what I mean? You wouldn't think, well, there's some special thing. You just cut a square and cut it in half, surely.
But I think when you're a beginner, you'd think that you cut a load of triangles out and stitch those together. But the thing that you'll find very difficult about that, as we all know, we've got the grain of the fabric. If you cut or sew across the grain... Can you see you've got that stretch? So if we were to cut these in half and then try and sew them with another half, the fabric would actually shift a lot.
Yes.
And for accuracy with patchwork, that's not what you want.
No, so of course not.
We need to keep very accurate. So the trick is to really think about what size finished square that you'd like to make. Because obviously this technique you can make into a quilt size, you can make it into anything. In fact, when I was making the book cover, I suddenly thought, ooh, a really nice lumbar cushion.
You got a bad back?
I have got a bad back. I've always had a bad back. So yes.
It's all those seafaring days, isn't it?
I think I fell from a climbing frame when I was small. I remember being doubled. Yeah, so I've always struggled. And I'm an ex-dancer. So that doesn't help.
We're learning lots today, aren't we? Well, we'll get back to the dancing stories later. So you see, this again, in my brain, I thought lots and lots of triangles sewn together.
Yeah.
But actually, what you're making, so what you're, it's one of the, I've just noticed over here, sorry, Rich. But what you're making is one of those, really, to start with, isn't it? Makes it so much simpler to then stitch together afterwards, doesn't it?
Yeah, rather than sewing all those triangles together. So there's a formula. So if you wanted the finished square, so that size square, actually when it's
I'll just put it everywhere it is then.
When it's sewed in to something, because this is obviously, this has got quarter inch seam allowance on. So the finished square there, if we wanted a 5-inch finished square, we add 7/8 of an inch. And so you cut your square 7/8.
Right, so just say that again.
Okay, so the finished square, stitched, not this, because that's not finished because it's not been stitched in.
Oh, okay. So the finished square here.
Yes.
Right.
So that's 2 3/4 because it's got its seam allowance.
Right.
The finished square here is 2 1/4 inches.
Right.
So if I add 7/8 to that,
same
formula. That's why I tried to say if you want 5-inch squares, finished squares, cut your squares 5 7/8. So what I've started with here, if that makes sense, this is a finished 2 1/4 square.
Yes.
I've cut these 3 1/8 because I've added the 7/8.
Okay.
If that makes sense.
So you've got any questions for Angela, just ring the call centre.
A little bit of maths. Or
send it in now, because you'll take questions now, won't you, during the show?
Yeah, of course.
If you go on the web and do a web chat straight through Tanner, or email in studio@sewingquarter.com. If you've got any questions for Angela, she's here till 12 o'clock. If you want to ask any questions, please, please, please do.
Yeah.
Okay, so.
So, for this project, I cut two squares of each of the fabrics, so that would give me 16, and 16 white squares. And just to show you a couple of half square triangles here, you can see what I've done is I've drawn a pencil line on the plain fabric, because it's easy to see, from corner to corner. And that's going to give me a guide. I'm actually going to sew either side a quarter of an inch.
Okay.
This, obviously, on a plain fabric, you can't really tell which is the wrong or right side. So that would be on the wrong side. If you were doing it with two pattern fabrics, you would put right sides together.
Now, you've used a pencil.
I have.
Could you use the vanishing marker that we've got?
I love pens that disappear for some applications, but for this application, you're actually going to end up cutting this line, so it's never going to be seen in your work. So
fine.
I wouldn't waste your special ink.
Your magic ink.
Your magic ink.
Magic disappearing.
There we go. Let me get me set up.
So So you're not sewing down the line then?
No, I'm actually sewing either side of the line.
Right.
So I've moved my needle across so that I've got it's in a quarter of an inch position. But I'm actually putting the edge of the foot on my pencil line, and then I'm going to sew down one side. There we go. Now, if you're doing lots of these, I like to chain piece. So I'll just give you a little demonstration of what that means, because some viewers might have heard about chain piecing.
This is what I'd call tailgating, isn't it? Excuse me.
So we've left that one under the machine, and we're just off the edge. And then we just get another one prepared. It's a bit like, because it's a bit like a traffic jam, isn't it?
Yes, not by tailgate, not like condone tailgating whatsoever.
I can just lift the foot with the needle down, get the next one lined up on my pencil line and continue. And then you're not wasting thread, it's very speedy, you're not wasting time taking them out from under the machine. So sew down one side. And then, without snipping them apart. So if you were doing, a pile of them, you end up with a load of bunting, actually. It looks like bunting.
Or kites, lots of kites.
Yeah. So now I'm going to sew down the other side.
Right. Oh, so because they're all joined together, you just have them all, and then you just sew down
so
the other
side. So you can, just go the other side. There we go. You do need a little bit more patience with half square triangles than you would with squares.
But the thing is, it's part of the joy, isn't
it?
It's all part of the...
You can just take your time. Yes. Yeah, still no... Oh, I shouldn't be looking at you, really.
Now, when we were practising, before all you experts came on board, Natasha and I used to pretend one would be guest, one would be a presenter, and then one day... Natasha wasn't here, so producer Hannah had to. And she looked this one up and she thought, well, I'll do this one. I've never seen anybody get so complicated. It was such a simple way. I just want to show you here. So there's the Angela's pencil line down the middle, there. And you've just stitched quarter of an inch that side and quarter of an inch that side.
Yes.
And that's
right.
It.
That's okay. Simple as that. I'm going to snip these apart. And now I'm going to...
It's a very, very simple technique too. It's just Hannah couldn't understand it, that was all.
A lot of people... there are other patchwork techniques where you do sew on the pencil line.
Oh, okay.
Or, so she may have got confused.
Yeah, well, it's not difficult.
When you draw a pencil line, you expect to be stitching on it in a way, don't you?
Exactly.
So then you can just line the rule up on the pencil line, and we're just going to cut right down the centre. I'm going to do this one. Might as well do this one as well.
Yeah. So you're now cutting on the pencil line.
Cutting on the pencil line.
Tippy toes. I love the way you all have to go on tippy toes to do the cutting with the rotary.
Have we got the iron ready to
press? I'll get it ready. Oh, it's on, yes.
Yeah, we're okay with that.
Right, hang on, I just have to make space.
So, it's quite fun when you're doing a big project like this because you end up with a huge pile. Well, that's fun if you like pressing.
Yeah, okay, there you go. There you go.
Thank you.
I'll move across. Now, if you miss anything, you can always watch. We're live from 8 till 12 every morning on Freeview 78 and on the internet. But you can also watch us on the web. You just did the web. Oh, hang on. There's something new then. There's something new since I was last in. You can watch us on YouTube.
Oh.
So then you can pause it. So, you can still watch on the web, can you? Okay, right. Okay, this is all new to me. I'll just explain this to you, right? So we're live on Freeview 78 from 8 to 12 every day. And then on our website, the shows are then on loop for every 4 hours. Loop. But you can't pause that one. The shows are also on YouTube, where you can pause them and things like that. And I presume, do they get the link to YouTube from our web then, Hannah? Oh, right. What you need to do is ring the call centre and they'll tell you how to get it. I think it's called Search for Sewing Quarter on YouTube and you should find it. Okay, I didn't know that. There you go.
That's brilliant. A lot of people were asking me.
Oh, Sally missed some bits, that was all. No, Sally, if you go to YouTube after the show, I presume it'll be after midday, they'll be uploaded or whatever it's called then. Anyway.
So, we've pressed those just to show you that we've got these lovely crisp half-square triangles now.
Yeah.
If you're, a little tip if you're working with light-coloured fabrics is to press to the dark side.
Yeah. My new catchphrase, that.
The way I always remember to get it the right way around is to have your dark fabric on the top.
Okay.
Press that and then, as you then press over with the iron, so your seam is sitting behind the darker fabric, because otherwise if it sits behind, you can't avoid it with all projects,
sometimes
you will get some seams showing, but that's the way we do that.
On the whole, okay, brilliant.
So you do that for all of your 16 squares, you'd end up with 32, because you'd started with 16 coloured fabrics and 16 white.
So you've now got
32
party coloured squares.
Yes.
Triangle. And what are those things you're cutting off at the end there?
So these are known as dog ears.
Dog ears! ends, dog tails, dog legs ears. Earlier. No, doggy ears.
No cruelty.
Okay, no.
We've got some. Yes. Did I have some nice snips actually?
Oh, what are these?
Snips, yeah. Oh, I haven't tried these. These look. I saw someone using these the other day. I thought these look very nice. Let's give these a go.
The fist, because you go to the web, I check them out on the web. Very easy. You've got a spring inside them, haven't they?
They're lovely. So that's a tutorial on how to make your half square triangles.
Right.
And snip those off, get rid of those. So you do that for all your fabrics.
Yeah.
Can I just say, if someone hasn't tried ever using half square triangles, they're really fun. And they don't just make this pattern. What I'd suggest is just take two fabrics and make a load of half square triangles out of just two fabrics, and actually then play around with them on a table and move them around. You can make chevrons, stars, all sorts of things. So that's really good.
So just play around with it before you sew it together.
Exactly.
The fabrics are, here you go, they're exclusive. Now, the Dashwood fabrics you will have seen available at Dashwood, but we are the only people, as far as we know, that have the Paper Meadow range in the Fat Quarter. In the Fat Quarter. It's exclusive to us here at Sewing Quarter. In a minute, I will go through, or in 10 minutes, I will go through all of the different fabrics that are in the parcel so you can see all the beautiful, beautiful colours. Because I want you to see Angie now just moving and arranging her squares.
I'm trying to follow my pattern here to see where I am. They're the wrong way around, that's why. So, yes, this is gets tricky now. So lay your squares.
But this
out.
Is where the joy of it is, isn't it?
Yeah.
For you to actually lay it out.
That's it. That's what I'm saying. If you make them all in just a two-tone, not all these patterns, then it's really
fun. If you just do it with two to start with, you're saying, then you can. Yeah.
It's really fun. You can make lots of different blocks. So I'll just show you what they look like when they start to come together. Oh, there this is.
No pressure.
I love this one. It's a bit like, you know, your hole punch.
Oh, yes.
And then the back comes off and you get the whole bunch of things everywhere. It's really, really lovely. So I think we've got a little point over there and then some corners. There we go. Because you see you've got these diagonals going on as well as...
Now, did you already know you've got one missing? Oh, no, it's piled in.
No, that's the old ones. Oh, there you go.
Which one's supposed to be in there? It's one with that.
That's okay. We can go with this for now. That's bizarre. Maybe I've got two stuck together. You have to be careful of that, too.
Is it not one of these? Is it that
one? Oh, it could be that one, actually. Yeah. There we go.
See, I do have my uses.
Thank you, John.
So, yeah,
so there you go. When you've got all your squares prepared, lay them out. I suggest doing a 16 at a time, because yes. you can see how that was quite so strenuous.
Now, did you know that pattern straight away, or was that literally just sitting there with them all and moving them round and seeing different shapes?
Plain, I did sketch. I knew I wanted to make this block, so sketched that first, and then, of course, working out that I'd got 8 fabrics to play with was perfect. So I've just used, as I say, 4 in the diamond there and 4 in the diamond on the back.
Mm. Well, a lot of people do drawings and use inspiration from, like we saw the patchwork earlier, inspired from my, you weren't here, it was gorgeous, this patchwork quilt, that same as a stained glass window, and it was beautiful.
Yeah, lovely.
So there's an art in the laying out. So really, it's all about the prep, isn't it? Because you don't want to start halfway through and think, where was I going to put that one again?
Yeah.
Have it laid out. Maybe take a picture on your phone so you know exactly how you're going to be doing it if you haven't already drawn it out. So what's the next stage then?
So the next stage then that I do is start sewing these together.
Right.
And you can go about this in different ways. I like to sew in rows.
Mm-hmm.
You could sew 4 together. You know, you sort of find your own way.
Okay.
Or work in rows.
Yes.
If we start by sewing these two together, this is why it's easier if they're laid out.
Yes.
So we're going to join these two, just with, a straight seam down here.
Uh-huh.
And again, you can do this chain piecing.
Oh, yes, of course.
So that speeds things up again.
Which is why, in a way, it's good that you've got your picture. Once you place them all, take a quick picture of it.
Yes.
Because you're going to now not ruin the design, but take that design completely to pieces, aren't you? Because if your tail... Not tail, okay. Yeah. Sorry.
Chain piecing, so
chain
I take
piecing.
The next one.
They're all going to be on there rather than on here, do you know what I mean?
That's right. We just place the next one. If I just do a block of 4... Maybe to show the view.
As many as you like.
Yeah.
It's your show. You are the organ grinder.
No,
I am
but
just
I don't,
a monkey.
I'd like, there's lots to show in this.
You want to get it finished, for
a little book cover, there are quite a few techniques to show.
Yeah, but that's good, isn't it? Because there's so many different techniques. Oh, yes, you've got quilting as well,
quilting,
and binding.
A bit of quilting and binding later,
So just your block of 4, then,
I might just join the top 4 rather than all these, but this is just.
Yeah.
I'm a bit strange. I can't help a bit of chain piecing.
Oh, really? It's your little addiction.
Send me all you piecing. I'm quite happy. Chugging it out of the back of the machine. There we go.
We've had a message from an old friend of mine and Hannah's, Dawn Big Bird's watching. Hello, hello, Dawn Big Bird. She said she's never done stitching or sewing before, but she's fascinated and addicted to the channel already. Thank you, Dawn Big Bird. No bracelets here, I'm afraid.
I've snipped these two off because we're just going to concentrate on 4.
Yes.
But you can leave them, in a chain.
Yes.
And then you can start attaching the next row.
Oh, but does that not get messy with all the little bits of thread? That's because you like the challenge, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, it does hold it all in the correct order.
Oh, yes, of course it does.
So what I'm going to do now, if you don't mind, is press those.
Not at all.
Okay. So this is now where we can't do pressing to the dark side necessarily. So just press to reinforce the seam that you've stitched, press it flat, and then with the iron just push the top layer over to get that nice crisp. Press on there, thank you. And so we've got our first chevron, if you like, appearing. And then when you've done all that, the process, then we need to join them this way.
Yes.
Okay. Actually... There we go. I'm going to press this one the other way.
Oh.
Let me press this one this way. Because what's nice to happen is that your seams sit on opposite sides. Okay. There we go.
As well as the big iron, we've just had a mini iron in the last show.
Okay.
You could almost, when the squares are this size,
small,
use your mini iron.
Small
you,
patchwork.
Yes.
Yeah.
But well, I suppose when it gets bigger and bigger, then you can move to the main iron.
The mini irons are really nice for patchwork, applique as well.
Oh, yes, yeah.
Appliquing little shapes down.
Yeah.
So now you can see I'm matching this centre seam here, my two seams I've pressed in opposite directions.
Pin.
A very fine pin.
Oh, and fine.
That's a knitting needle.
Oh, I do apologise. Is that fine enough?
That one. Thank you. With the little glass-headed ones.
Oh, okay.
The other glass-headed ones.
Yeah.
So what I'm going to do here now is pop it through. I know we're so fussy about our pins.
No, and so you should be.
I just got my finger then, just for the...
Yeah, good. Yeah. That's divine retribution there, you see. Picking on me.
So I'm putting the pin in this actual line of stitching.
Yeah.
And really near the top. And we can just check. It's not quite, can you see? It's not quite sitting properly. So... half square triangles and these kind of points where you want to match them, you do want to get them really precise.
These are different to the glass-headed pins we showed earlier. I'm going to show you the difference, right? While you're doing that, yeah. I'll just bring these in. So these... I'll wait for...
That's
oh, can I do that? These are the ones I showed earlier, which are the long,
long
quilters one with the glass-headed pins. These are the ones that Angela's using, which are the ones on your screen now. The glass-headed pins, nickel, 34mm, £3.45.
So patchwork for patchwork.
So it's how fine they are, because that's very, very fine.
Yeah.
All right, thank you. I think we should have different pin cushions with different pins and
I
not
think
mix
so.
Them.
I think so.
I'll sort that out.
It's quite... I didn't realise the big thing with pins before I did any patchwork, and then you really realise the difference between, you know, dressmaking pins and...
well, even in dressmaking, because if you're making a really flimsy 1930s bias cut silk dress, you want the thinnest, sharpest pins possible.
Like
if
a silk
you're using
pin.
A wool worsted or something, then you want the nice, sturdier pins.
I know.
So now you're just stitching.
Just stitching down there, straight down that seam. Pop that pin back in there. And then we get that opening up there. So then you'd continue to do that until you've got all of your front together, and then do the same with your back, pressing it as you go on each seam to keep it nice and sharp. Okay, then...
Okay, now, what's the next stage? Have we come to a natural end of a stage because someone wants to see the fabrics?
Okay.
So do you mind if I just leave you for a second?
Fine.
Don't do anything without me.
I won't.
And somebody wants to see the fabrics in the fat quarter, and I just happen to have them all here. Here we go. Now, this is the fat quarter. This is how it comes. Exclusive to us now. You will have seen the fabrics before, maybe, if you've been to the Dashwood shop or the Dashwood website. But we are, as far as we know, at this moment in time, we're the only people to bring you this Dashwood Paper Meadow in the fat quarter, £19.95. You're getting a lot of fabric there for £19.95. And you know, if you've bought Dashwood before, the quality is just beautiful. Right, look at these prints. Now, this is a fat quarter. This is the size of your fat quarter, right? So it's really, really, and you know what? It's big enough, isn't it, to make the back of a cushion or many other things if you don't want to cut up and make a patchwork out of it. But the joy of this is they've teamed the fabrics that work together because it's all from the same collection. So we start off with that one, which is like fishes and leaves, it looks like there. Then we've got this one, which is just beautiful, isn't it? That it's got like a period feel to it, but with a modern twist that's got writing all over it and everything. That's lovely. Then look at that one. That's gorgeous. That's like beautiful, beautiful little geometric print there. Then this one, look at this. This is like a 1940s House on the Prairie print, isn't it? But with a modern twist to it. Lovely navy blue on there. Then look at that. This is Hannah's favourite. Look at that lovely retro print there. Really, really gorgeous. Then there's this one. £19.95. Oh, it works out at £2.49 a piece of fabric, which is amazing. Now, there's the one that Angie was talking about earlier, which is like the hole punch, where the back falls off and all the hole punch things go over the back. And then that's lovely. I like that one. That's a very kind of small, subtle design there. So you get all of that for £19.95. Yours don't come sewn together. We've obviously sewn together just to out of ease for you to be able to see them. Yours comes in the most gorgeous, there you go, that's how yours arrive, for £19.95. Okay, I'm going back.
All I've done, John, while you were away, right. is I've fitted my walking foot now.
Oh, okay.
Because
okay.
ready for some quilting, so right. I've just fitted that. So once you've got all of your top together...
So is this now the size of the finished
yes.
for the book that we're doing?
For an A5 diary or notebook, I think this is about 18 inches long. Actually, the width doesn't make that much difference, because if you don't get it quite right, it's folded inside
yes,
anyway.
Exactly.
This way, it's about 9.5 inches, just giving you a little bit of room to get the book in there.
Okay.
So just when you're working your sizes out to the book you're using.
So you've stitched all of your half-square triangles, is that what they call them? Half-square triangles
yes.
together?
Yeah, so you'd end up with just a big piece of
yes.
cloth pieced like that. And then you'd want to choose a fabric for your backing.
For the
I've
inside.
I've used different
of the
ones
yes.
here out of the collection. So,
lovely.
Yeah, for the inside.
And you've sandwiched
and
your wadding.
Sandwiched it with the wadding. As on my earlier show, I don't know if the same people are watching, but just because
everybody
it's
tunes in for you.
All morning, stay there fixed.
Yes.
I've just used the basting spray.
This?
Yep. A nice quick project.
We love this. We love this. So just explain how it works.
So you can see it's holding everything in place, but it is just slightly tacky. I could just feel that then pulling away.
Yeah.
You can see.
Oh, yes.
So
yes,
if
yes.
you don't, if you peel the top back, spray it on your wadding, flatten out your cloth again, and it will just hold everything in place to save you hand basting
yes,
if you're in a hurry.
And then what were you saying about the people who might have been watching earlier?
No, I was just saying that...
Oh, about
yeah,
the spray.
Yeah, about the spray, in case we... You didn't catch it earlier. So that's, and then we just start quilting. Now you can quilt whatever pattern you like, as much or as little as you like again. Here I started by following almost a figure eight.
Yes.
So I just followed that round, because the least time I have to break my thread, the better. And that
yes.
just held everything quite stable. And then I've just started to do sort of a quarter inch echo around that. This is quite nice in the centre here, so this is what I thought I'd do.
Oh, yes,
around
yes, yes, yes.
the centre.
Now, is
here.
That what you... That's not free, that's not...
No, it's just with straight stitching with the walking foot on and just keeping an accurate quarter inch. It's spiralling round on itself.
And is a walking foot essential?
I think you would start, if you're pushing this fabric around with a normal foot, I think you would start to see some puckers.
And if you haven't got a walking foot,
yeah.
Most sewing machine
manufacturers, yeah, you can buy it. Just like you could buy a blind hem stitch foot or a, you know, what concealed zipper foot. You can buy all these attachments for your
exactly.
sewing machines, yeah. Okay, so I'm just going to take this to the machine now. It's set with the needle across, as before, quarter of an inch.
Right, before we go any further, before
okay.
we start stitching, we had a message from Tracy, who says, can you use, I can half answer this because we half answered it in the last show, but can you use a walking stitch for anything else apart, a walking foot for anything else other than quilting?
Absolutely. As I mentioned earlier, if I was turning curtains up now, if you turn a hem, you've got three layers of fabric. Anytime you've got more than two pieces of fabric, you know, if you're getting into that layering, put your walking foot on, it really does help.
And also, say you're in the middle of doing quilting,
yeah.
and then suddenly you think, oh, I've just got to stitch that seam up. Can you still do a normal straight stitch on it as well? Or would you take it off and put the original foot back on?
I think if you were doing something as delicate as piecing, like two flimsy bits of cotton,
yes.
It might be a bit
so
heavy.
You would swap. So
yeah,
really,
but,
yes, but you can use it
but you
for
can.
Other things,
yeah.
Okay,
it clips
off very easily on this machine.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm going to let you do it. So
that's okay. So I'm just keeping the edge of the foot in line here with my coloured fabric, just along that line. This just takes a little bit of concentration and a bit of... I'm going to stop the needle, I think is around a quarter of an inch.
Yeah.
Oh. Spin round. If it's still a bit too far away, that's not a problem because I've left my needle down. I can just do one more stitch and then swivel that round. So then that's lying along the next side. And I just continue like that. Going to go around there again. What I find with this technique is sometimes you have to just alter your stitch length. So if you only needed a little tiny stitch, you can just do that for one stitch.
Yes, yes, yes.
Just to make it the right size. It's almost like the right size step almost to miss the puddle. You just go around like that. And just keep going. And again, just pushing out, keeping everything nice and flat as you go. Now here I'm going to stop a quarter of an inch away from my first row of stitching. It's a little bit difficult to see, isn't it? I guess white on white.
Yes, that's the designer's choice.
Gives a nice effect. I should have done it and changed my thread colour.
But you could do it in any of the colours.
You could do it in a...
There in the Dashwood fabric. Absolutely. And the navy, the flame, the pale blue. You can do them in any colour you want, really.
And depending on your pattern that you've decided to put together with half square triangles, you could do nice traditional... I love a traditional classic cross hatch.
That's like a Sloan Ranger's jacket. Those don't know, a crosshatch is like, you know, the handbags and the jackets you get, the Sloan Ranger jackets, that's very much like that, the crosshatch.
Like country jackets and things, yeah. So I'm getting smaller. Gets quicker as I get round smaller.
Yeah. I'm staying quiet because everyone loves to see the demonstration, so I'm just keeping quiet while you do it.
I thought someone switched my power off then.
What?
I thought someone had switched the power off the machine then. So I was being a bit too fast with the foot pedal. I think it wasn't reacting. There we go. Almost there.
Yeah, that's fine. There's no rush.
That's good.
It's really lovely to watch. I bet it's lovely to sit at home on a Saturday watching all this... craft, well, every day, but you know, especially on a Saturday when you've got most people, Creativity Saturday, let's call it.
That's really nice. I know lots of people that have been enjoying it. That's good, including myself.
So when you get to the middle,
So I'm getting there now, I think. So then I'm just going to sew up to one row of stitching.
Yeah,
I can just see. I'm just going to do a little back stitch there. Oh, there we go. And we'll chop that off. So I think we're there. There we go. But it's a lovely... It's one of the reasons I started quilting, because I'm really from an embroidery background, free motion embroidery. I actually love the way things feel when they've been quilted, and I wanted to apply that to my work. But it's just all the lovely textures as well. So, of course, you could quilt over all of this.
Yes, if you wanted to,
As I say, but it's lovely when they catch the light. They're really nice.
And also, it gives the fabrics all different textures, doesn't it? So you think you have the same fabric, but the different textures. Completely different. This looks completely different to that fabric, even though it's exactly the same fabric. It's just the quilting makes it look completely different, doesn't it?
And on this finished one, I have done more sort of quarter seams in this area here, but you can do as little or as... You just keep quilting. Or like you say, in coloured threads, even. It would be very neat if you're doing it in contrasting threads.
Exactly. These are... Now, if you're looking, thinking, those are lovely fabrics, John. They're Dashwood. They're the Dashwood Paper Meadow. Now, it's an exclusive today. You might have seen the fabrics before, but that's the wrong thing to say. To our knowledge, that we are the only people at this moment in time to bring you this range of the Dashwood Paper Meadow in the Fat Quarter. In the Fat Quarter. And it's lovely being able to buy a Fat Quarter because you get a piece of each of the fabrics. Do you know what I mean? There are 8 completely different fabrics in there. They're not small. Well, you know, if you've seen the advert, I'll just explain. What they do to get a Fat Quarter is they get a yard of fabric and they cut it in half that way and cut it in half that way. So you're getting one of the, you know...
Like half a metre wide. Yeah. And for this project, I literally used 6 inches by 3 inches, that's all.
Yeah, so you've got the rest of it to play with for other projects later.
So okay. That's great. So if you'd quilted that as much as you'd wanted to, then we're down to trimming now. So I'm just going to square this off.
Right, while you're squaring that off, why did you choose to go with the white background when you could have had putty or you could have had coral?
Well...
Actually,
I didn't get any planes from Sewing Quarter. I just got the bundle. And then I was looking at them just thinking, for me, they just spoke white just to keep it nice and fresh. But I love, actually, if you were making a bigger quilt with this, those other colours are lovely. I really like the putty.
So, thank you. I love the putty as
well. Yeah, I do.
I love the putty. It's just Hannah.
It's just Hannah, not like the putty.
Have you got a picture? If you have a look at the fabric over there, you see, it's the middle one. The putty one is middle. And you know putty hat has that beige slash pinky tone to it. Well, that's the same. Fabulous cotton, £3.25 for half a metre, right? And beautiful, good for your stash. The one at the top is coral, and the one at the bottom is white, the one we're using on this as well. Okay. Oh, I won't go through them all again later.
We've got this new mat
folding
that I'm
mat, yes.
trying today, yes. Quite a nice little size, isn't it?
The thing is, it's a fantastic size when it's open like that. Yeah. You haven't got much room to put away afterwards. There are lots of people who work on their dining room table or something like that. Fold it up and put it away. But also, it means you can use it as a smaller board if you want to. If you're doing very soft little pieces, then
but
you could.
Also, if you go to a sewing group, patchwork group, or and you have to take all these things with you, it's really nice to be transportable.
Do your ladies have to bring all things
yeah.
with them?
Yeah.
Oh, so I couldn't just turn up one day then?
No. Well, you could.
And gentlemen. Still, I like to call them ladies.
We'd still let you in.
Yeah, but I wouldn't be able to do anything because I haven't brought any tools with me.
No, that's right. So I'm just on the last one now. Squaring this off. On my tiptoes. I'm going to have to get me some heels, John.
Yes. Heels are a box.
Yes.
Let me just be taller than me for the whole show then.
There we go.
I'll just show you this yeah. board because it's a really lovely... Okay. You see, it folds away. So if you want to use a smaller board, if you're working on more intricate shapes, you can have the smaller one. This happened last time you were in. I got covered in threads. Or, of course, you can open it out like that. It's a self-healing, a really lovely self-healing cutting mat. £23.95. That one is 60 by 45 centimetres. Okay.
So now we're coming on to the finishing for the binding. You can use pre-double folded binding and stitch that on.
Yes.
I'm going to use just a single binding.
One of the Dashwood fabrics from the factory.
Yes. Yeah. So it's the same technique as on the cot quilt earlier, except I've not, because we don't want so much bulk, because it's just a bulk, a book cover.
Yes.
Instead of cutting my strip at 2.5 inches and then folding it double, it only needs single, for this book cover.
Right.
So I've cut this at 1.5 inch.
Right.
Because we're just going to use it single, not mm-hmm. double. And I'll stitch around here, I think. So again, we've got the raw edge just folded in.
And it's straight binding again, isn't it?
Straight binding. Yeah. If I was doing this, I'd start here on one of the short edges,
right?
Because then your join will end up on the bit that
on the inside
folded in.
Yes.
But because I'm just going to go around a couple of corners, I'm going to start here. But and so we haven't got sort of raw edge and folded edge with this one. We're just raw edge because we haven't folded the fabric.
Of course.
And I'm just again using 1/4 inch as my seam.
So how wide did you say you'd cut that, sorry?
1.5 inches, rather than the double folded binding is 2.5
yes.
inches. It doesn't really need to be that robust. So I'm going to sew along here until I'm about 1/4 inch away from the corner. Just lengthen my stitch a little. Sometimes on a walking foot, it's quite useful to either with a pen or a little tiny bit of coloured tape to mark where 1/4 inch forward of the needle is.
Of course, yes.
So if you're
only do that if the machine is yours.
Yeah.
Don't go to the shop and borrow one and put it on there.
My 1/4 inch foot's actually got markers on the actual foot forwards.
So you've taken it out.
But on the walking foot, they don't, do they? Yeah. I'm taking it out. I'm trying to get the thread cut there. There we go. So we've stopped just from the edge there. I have to turn this around and remember the formula.
Yes.
Fold it away from yourself at a 45-degree angle, making a point to the corner, and then fold that side down. Lovely wonder clips to hold everything in place. Just while we carry it to the machine, and then I'll do another corner.
Why are you using wonder clips rather than pins at that stage?
I think they're super fast just to nip on. We're not doing anything for accuracy, sort of pinning matching points or seams or anything like that. So they just hold everything in place. I think initially they were designed with bag makers mind, so with thicker fabrics and lots of wadding and stabilisers, and just fabulous.
They are brilliant, aren't they?
I always use them for binding. And then I just repeat the process. Shall I do another corner? Or?
Yeah, go on. All right. Got plenty of time.
That's good. So again, stop a quarter of an inch from the end. Take it from underneath the machine. Fold away from yourself. Just finger press your crease and fold this over. Again, the same process I forgot to mention, actually, the length of your binding. If you add up all four sides of your project and then add a few inches.
I was going to say, you wouldn't add 10 inches for this, would you?
No, I think this came to about 54 and I just rounded it up to 60 inches. Yeah. It's about a metre and a half, actually. You wouldn't believe that.
No, you forget, don't you, really?
So...
And there's your Wonder Clips again going on. Clover Wonder Clips, the pack contains 10 for £7.95. That lovely luminous colour, so you're not going to forget them anywhere, are you?
No.
This is a half open packet, this one. This isn't how yours will arrive.
10, yeah. So if I just stop there.
Add them to your order, £7.95, okay?
There we go. So you continue round until you get back to where you started. And then. We should have lovely mitered corners.
So you don't cut away. You don't cut away any of the seam allowance on this one, do you?
No, anything. Because what the pocket, you'd think sometimes, oh, I need to cut that away because it's going to be too bulky. But what the fabric does on the other side is create the other mitre on the other side, the other little pocket. So just by hand, then you can fold under and slip stitch that down.
Now on the cot, I said, oh, you could, if you wanted to, you could machine it. But I think on this, it'd be nice to hand stitch it because it's going to look like it's a personal. I was just thinking it's not too long. No. And also look at the quilt cover. I think it's going to be going in the washing machine every other day, isn't it? I think. Whereas this could be, you know, those days when you've had a row with your husband, you think because you've been in your sewing room for too long,
you think you want to sit in the same room as him. Yes.
So you can go down, pretend you're with him.
Yeah.
And yeah, sit with him, but don't speak to him and do your stitching.
That's right. It's nice to have a bit of hand stitching to do sometimes. Yes. Yeah. And actually, I often thought that surely slip stitching, it's not that robust to last on a quilt being washed. But it's
just depends how well you do it.
It is actually quite robust. Yeah.
Does your husband do any? Because he's an artist, isn't he? Does he do any sewing?
Actually, we're really into historical narrowboats, and because I'm sewing sort of 1940s period quilt at the moment, I'm doing hexes, I've got him rag rugging.
So oh, wow.
He'll kill me for telling everyone that now, won't he?
We don't know who he is, but I will reveal him one day.
He's trying to get me crocheting, and I'm not a crocheter, I'm a knitter. So I've told him he can go to crochet lessons if he wants to.
Without him?
Yeah. But he's making a rag rug for the boat, so that's nice.
Okay. That looks so neat, doesn't it?
It is. It's a lovely way. I prefer not to see any.
No. I was literally just thinking, because the hand stitching does make it very personalised, doesn't it? But I was just thinking about if your hand stitching isn't robust, isn't sturdy, that if you're,
especially for a baby quilt,
it's going to need to be washed lots and lots of times.
Yeah.
Okay. So you then do that all the way around the edge.
All the way around. And then what I'd done, it's not that necessarily, but what I did on this one was just put a row of stitching. I've worked the measurements out to this, that we're actually going to fold this on one of these pieces.
Okay.
So I'd work the pattern out to that. And I did just add another row of stitching. So that's where we're going to fold it. So then you would just fold your, when you've got all your binding on, fold that down. Again, you could be using your Wonder Clips then when everything's in place to hold this secure. And all you need to do is put a single row of stitching just along there.
Yeah.
And if you do it from the front, because that's what you're going to see, it doesn't really matter, I don't know if you can see on this one, if it goes a bit off from the back,
yes,
like there, it doesn't really matter, that's on the inside of the book. But that just holds the pockets, just simply.
And did you practice, because at that point, when you were folding those in,
yeah,
did you think, oh, before I stitch it, I'll just slip my book in to make sure the book either isn't going to fall out or
that's
it's
right,
too short for that?
That's right. I mean, I'd work this pattern out to go on that, but if the pattern doesn't, you know, that doesn't determine the pattern, definitely find out, put the book in, and like you've just done, fold the book. Because when this is folded round, it uses a lot more fabric than,
yes,
if you just lay that out. You'll feel, actually, can you feel, there's actually quite a lot of room,
oh,
in,
yes,
the edge,
but
of there.
But there's going to need to be.
For the fold, so yeah, definitely put your fabric round, fold it, and then wonder clip it in place. Good point. Before you stitch that down, otherwise you'll yeah, think,
yes,
that, think that that's it, and then you won't be able to,
yes, exactly,
close your,
exactly,
book.
Now, so, yeah, I've got, somebody's just asked, I don't know if we've got a square, they missed the beginning of the show and they were just saying, how did you get the triangles exactly to look as they do, because they're so kind of precise? Could you just go through that, you know, with the line and everything,
yes,
at the beginning? I don't know if we've actually got one,
I
but
don't
just
think I'd,
no, but
yeah,
just
I think
explain
I did too,
what,
didn't
how
I?
You got the
formula.
Yes.
So the formula for making half square triangles is to decide what size you want your finished square to be,
yes,
in your quilt. So if you wanted it finished to be 5 inches, then add 7/8. So then you cut all your squares to 5 inches and 7/8.
Yes.
And so you'd have two different fabrics on the, in this instance, a white and a pattern. On the plain fabric, I drew a pencil line from corner to corner. It doesn't really matter if it's pencil or a removable pen because you're not going to,
yes,
see it.
Yeah.
Place right sides of the fabrics, a plain and a pattern together, and with the pencil line. Don't stitch on the pencil line. Stitch 1/4 inch either side of the pencil line. Mm-hmm. Place your ruler and with a rotary cutter, slice down the pencil line, and then they will open out. You'll end up with four triangles,
yes,
but two, yeah, squares. Yes, if that.
Yeah, no, that's fine. It was just something.
Yeah.
But you know, if
someone
you've
missed
it, if you missed it, you can now search on YouTube for Sewing Quarter after the shows have happened and all of the shows. Because even though we show them on our website, you can't pause them. You have to watch them. If you do pause them and come back
and
then
loop,
press the play,
they?
It's jumped to where it should be.
It's
but
fantastic.
On YouTube, you can stop and start as much as you want. And all of the shows are going onto YouTube.
That's fantastic.
Straight. You're going to be a YouTube star, are you?
Well, that means that people can watch them when they're ready to watch them rather than missing it on the loop.
Exactly.
So
also, if they order this fabric now, the fabric will be with them in 4 to 6 working days. They might have forgotten by then how to do it, might they? So then they can go to YouTube in 4 to 6 working days
actually,
and start working through it.
Good point.
When are you in next then?
I'm in, it was going to be next Saturday, but I'm here on Wednesday.
Oh, I'm not.
Oh.
That's all right. That's all right. You have a lovely day with me. Oh, no, I wasn't meant to be. I was meant to be, but Natasha swapped us over. So she's now doing Wednesday and I'm doing next Saturday, the day you were supposed to be doing. Right, thank you ever so much for coming in and doing that.
That's
it's really, really interesting.
Nice.
A lot of people have commented about the other day when you did your
free motion quilting.
Yes, and they want...
I knew what you meant.
Well, if Hannah gives me messages without words, right? She goes, John, can you... and I know what she means, right? And you knew what
we
I meant by that.
We
it's just that we covered it a little bit, but people were saying they didn't
want
see enough
see
of it and they want to see more. So we need to get the scheduling department to schedule in more of...
Well, with my up-and-coming shows, I'll make sure that we get some more free motion
quilting. Exactly,
exactly.
Thank you ever so much. I'm going to leave you now. Go.
Okay.
Oh, do I have to show anything on this side before I go? No?
Yeah.
Okay then, right, okay. Thank you.
Thank you, it's been fun.
And will you be wearing a stripy top on Wednesday? I'm going to
probably,
tune in and watch.
Yeah,
I'm going to tune in and watch.
Stripy.
Right, I'm coming over here now with the finished product because I want to go through the fabric, right, the fat quarter. So, at this moment in time, you may have seen these fabrics. If you've been to the Dashwood website or buying Dashwood fabrics, you may have seen these fabrics before. But at this moment in time, what this exclusive is, we are the only people who are bringing you a fat quarter of all of those 8 pieces from the Paper Meadow range for £19.95. First of all, what I have to be your hands here, because the quality The quality of this cotton is beautiful. It's got a really, really fabulous feel to it. It's got a lovely weight to it as well. Really, really lovely weight to it. And as you can see in the fat quarter there, all the colours look amazing, don't they, together? These really, really fantastic colours that all go together so well. Now, maybe if you went into a fabric shop and you saw all of these colours and all these patterns together, you'd think, oh, I don't know if I'm... Because I don't know if it was Angela or Joe saying earlier, that's where they... No, I think it was Joe saying, where she was saying, that's what frightens her. When she goes and sees lots of different patterns, fabrics together, she's not confident enough. And this is an expert, this is a designer. And if she's not confident about it, then how on earth are we mere mortals supposed to make decisions? Whereas this, someone has taken that decision for you, haven't they? So you're getting a fat quarter of each piece from that collection. It is the Paper Meadow. I'll just take you through each of the fabrics because they are just exquisite, aren't they? If I just hold them up here, this is a beautiful one. It's like leaves and fishes almost, that one. They've got a kind of period feel to them. Oh, actually, I know why Angie likes this or these so much, because
they're very mid-century.
You've got, yeah, she's very mid-century. Not how old she is. She's a mid-century kind of girl, this one. Really, really, that's a fabulous pattern, that one, isn't it? Really gorgeous pattern. Using all the colours from all the different fabrics in the range there. Remember, you get all of this. Everything that I'm going to show you now, you get for £19.95. You're doesn't come like this. Yours will arrive obviously in the fat quarter like that. So that's the first fabric there. Then look at that. That is stunning. This is Hannah's favourite. It's really nice. It's got the flower print on it. Then it's also got writing. Look, it's got little writing, little bits of writing in the design there and everything. It's really, really lovely design, that one. So what else? I mean, not just the patchwork that we've done there. The back of a cushion, the front of a cushion, you can make that of that. A lumbar cushion you could make out of it. Look beautiful, wouldn't it? All sorts of things you could make out of that. Now, because it comes in the fat quarter, so it's a nice, nice big piece there, isn't it? Really, really lovely piece. That colour is lovely. It's like a coral orange colour, that one. Really, really lovely. Then we're moving on to this one. Now, I don't know why it is. It's funny, isn't it? I just love this one. It's like lots and lots of geometric... prints just spattered across the fabric. They're really, really lovely, aren't they? You've got the blue in there, the apricot, the gold, the white. And again, all these fabrics are going to look so gorgeous together, aren't they? £19. Now, not just £19.95 for that. You get all of these, remember, a fat quarter of all of these. Hannah worked out earlier. Was it £2.45 a piece of fabric, did you say? A fat quarter, did you say, Hannah? Okay, then this, I love this one. I love this one because this is very much like Little House on the Prairie, isn't it? Or Oklahoma or something like that. But it's got a kind of, it's got a period feel to it. It's got a modern twist to it. It's very clean, clean design. Do you know, I can see a shirt being made. If it was, I'll have to have one quarter of a shirt made out of that because it is just a beautiful, beautiful blue there with the golds and the oranges and the paler colours creating those flowers. Then let's move on. So this one, oh, this is nice. This is lovely. If you like 1950s, you know, do you know what? That'd be nice. You know the clock? No, remember, I don't know if there'd be enough there for a lampshade. We're doing a fat quarter. Mm. Little bedside lamp, but do you know what? The clock, you know the clock kit we do? That would look lovely, wouldn't it? As a clock, a fabric clock there. 1950s go beautifully. And then this one, which was the one we saw earlier, that's kind of like totem poles and flowers, and it's kind of got a really, really lovely feel to it. But do you know what? It is very geometric, but look at these flowers here. They're the same flowers that are on the orange fabric from earlier, just the same shape flower from the orange fabric earlier. Then this one. Now, Angie said earlier, you know when you've got a hole puncher and you do all your hole punching in different bits of paper and everything, and then suddenly the back falls off and all the little round things fall everywhere because they've like fallen, it's very rococo, it looks like they've just landed where they want to land and they've taken a snapshot of it. It's really lovely, isn't it? And then last but not least, this is really nice. This is a gorgeous, that's got more of a 70s kind of 70s feel to it, hasn't it, that one? But they're all very, very retro little boat shapes. They're very nautical but nice, that. So remember, that whole fat quarter at £19.95. Yours will arrive like this, looking gorgeous. Really, really stunning, isn't it? I've just got to tell you very quickly about the two books we've shown you today. We'll start off with All Things Quilting. Oops. All Things Quilting here. And my little thing just collapsed, haven't we? I don't care about the stand. I just want you to know about All Things Quilting. It's been quilting day today, hasn't it? And that is lovely. I love this book. I love that. I'm not going to get overexcited, I promise, but it's got techniques. It's got everything you need to know about starting the quilting before it even goes into different patterns, different shapes. It's really, really lovely. This one's £19.95. Everything you need to know. Everything. I love that one. I love that one there. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous? Everything you need to know about quilting in that one. That is the All Things Quilting. And then there's this one. This is the one I got overexcited about earlier. The Encyclopedia of Quilting and Patchwork. I've already bought this one. It's lovely. Well, I haven't paid for it yet. Really, really lovely. All the techniques. Because it's an encyclopedia, so it's got all the anything that any of our experts talk about at £12.95. Look, you see, it's even got inspiration. I'm not going to be able to find the one I love, am I? Just stunning. I've got to go. But I am back tomorrow. I am back tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock. Remember, you can ring the call centre if you missed anything. 0800 112 4433. Remember, you can watch any of the shows later on YouTube. I'm not sure what time they go up, but they'll go up on YouTube. So if you've missed anything or you want to watch Play and Pause, fabulous guests as always, Dave. Oh, they're already there, apparently. They're already on the YouTube channel already. So don't go anywhere. I will see you. Well, you can go now. You can enjoy your Saturday. I'll see you tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock with 4 brand new projects. Bye-bye.
Did you know there are multiple ways you can contact us, even if it's just to ask a question? Our friendly team are always on standby. You can call our customer service team at 0800 112 4433, email us at help@sewingquarter.com, visit our Facebook page, follow us on Instagram, follow us on Twitter at Sewing Quarter, and even message us through our website, and our presenters will answer your questions live on air.